All right, so emerging from the sewers into Abbott's Shore, you're spent from your journey. You hear end of the street as you look about. Some people are sort of surprised to see you emerge from the sewers. The stink of the area wafts over you as you stand about the street. Garibaldi gives you one last insult as you leave his company. Take care, you filthy half-breed. Abbott really? Shore is me? Much... Yeah.
Fuck you, Yang.
But I'm the coolest.
Everybody individually, you can think of whatever insult would be most prudent to each character. Abbott Shore is much as you remember it. Busy with folk going about the end of the day's work, closing shops. Just busy about the street.
Oh, Benzel, I will need control of my character sheet, sorry.
Of course.
No joking, Lamath.
So this is the New Age Benzel, or is it a different file?
No, it's the same one.
The New Age.
Okay. I need to open that, and I need to open that.
Okay, give this to Matt. There you go.
Cool.
You should have your control now. Okay.
I confirm.
Jack, you rent rooms at the Blue Boot unless anyone wants to stay elsewhere and perhaps take more expensive rooms.
Oh, Russell, are you in mine on purpose or by mistake?
Russell goes into campaigns and just leaves them open forever.
So I want to stay somewhere ritzier, please. Fuck.
This town at the Gilded Lamp?
Yeah.
Okay. That is fine.
I'm at each point.
So, yes, you... You make your way over to the Blue Boot. You are greeted by the owner and take in a hearty meal.
Oh, let's
what
not.
What is the cost for all this? I might sleep on the streets tonight.
I'll buy you a room at the rich place if you want.
Yeah. It's like
you're gonna get molested if you do that, though.
Something like 2 gold or something, I think. Yeah, I think so.
I'll take Les's offer of him buying me a room.
Quick note, GM, I don't have a token.
Oh, I didn't copy it. Oh, I'm sorry. Just a moment.
All right.
Is initiative dex plus base attack?
No.
Initiative is just dex bonus.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
SRD goes down, everyone just goes to shit.
It's up, though.
How do I attack?
Oh, thank God I updated this.
So you spend the evening at the Blue Boot Inn, or elsewhere, wherever you... For in Leslie's case. The next day, you all wake up. Is there anything specific you would like to do?
Gorgon's already got a wish list for mats that are all within the town's price range, as long as I can buy them.
Yeah, I need to get materials to start making alchemist fire.
That would be the point where Yang gets his bow. His improved bow.
Now, this is a little bit difficult
because... Also, have we cashed in our banknotes?
You have not, no.
Okay,
so if you want to make any purchases and it's over the amounts that you... You know, and it would include that amount because we haven't redistributed...
Oh, shit.
Able to take that into account yet.
Benzel drops intermittently. We just have to deal with it, I think.
Oh, did I drop?
For a second.
You just cut over.
Oh, okay. Did you guys catch all that? If it costs more than what you have available, minus, of course, the banknotes, you will have to go and redeem those beforehand.
Tomorrow we'll redeem the banknote.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, then I'll go shopping.
Certainly. We'll go shopping tomorrow, then.
So that's the first thing you want to do, probably, I guess?
Yeah. We're probably first ones in line to the bank.
Right.
Just this savage-looking group of people.
Payday on mercenaries.
All bleeding on the fucking floor.
I guess because...
Sorry, Anna had something to say?
Yeah, because Sveltna is going to be staying at, like, the Gilded Lamp or whatever, it's going to be difficult to track her down, but I'm going to try to do that.
You actually are going to stay with Leslie? That's interesting.
Well, not with me, in a different room.
Right.
Oh, okay.
I'm just trying to find Sveltna the next day.
I think that everybody's going to meet up, so you could probably just, like, quickly speak with her in private.
Yeah, I'm kind of going to do that. Anna's
depends on how private you want it to be.
Yeah, Anna will approach Sveltna and...
probably be a big bitch.
Say, I don't have much to take care of in Aperture, but if you'd like, I could accompany you.
I would like that.
Okay.
I have some shopping I need to do. You can come with me.
We did it. That was our
get a hero point.
Good RP, guys. Yeah,
the party.
Can I get a hero point? So, as Anna sort of accompanies Sveltna to various shops, as they're walking from place to place, like, you know, there's this is after going to a few locations, because Anna, I just need to buy sling bullets and that's about it. Anna says, so I haven't asked, as she sort of browses some wares nearby, why do this?
I could ask you the same thing. I just kind of got caught up in it.
No, I don't mean like with us. I mean this, and sort of like indicates the face mask.
I don't want it getting out who my family is.
Anna's brow sort of furrows. You don't think that eventually it's going to come out?
Eventually, yes, but I would like to forego that as long as possible.
I suppose. Where did this training come from? You never told me.
Oh, when my brother died, I went a little crazy. I started hearing voices, and this kind of helped with it.
Anna sort of like looks perturbed for a moment, and then when you
mention, it's a little disconcerting.
When you mention voices, Anna says, "Believe it or not, I can sympathize."
That's good, Camry.
And what about Les? What's going on between you two?
Someone in the street yells, "Just fuck already!"
He's done some less than reputable things trying to figure out my identity. I don't know why you're so obsessed with it. No one else seems to have a problem with it.
You don't have to tell me. After what happened with Garibaldi, I don't know. I don't know if this is for me.
If what's for you?
This. All of this. It's exciting and there's things that I hope to learn, but I don't know. Between him and Gamry, I didn't come here to die, you know?
I do one thing and all of a sudden I'm crazy.
Look, if you want to leave, I would understand that. Then I'd come with you.
Really? Then why come with him at all? I thought I was following you.
Whoops!
I'm staying here to keep you alive. I can't keep losing people out of my life.
You can't be serious. Listen,
Svelte
I would
Knight.
Be doing this whole fighting business whether I was here or not. I would just rather be here knowing that you're in danger.
But then why are you here? I wasn't even introduced to them until, you know, you were there.
I was just following them around Dunford because they were looking into something that happened in my father's mill. Then you joined up with us. And then you seemed to stay.
Look, then... Oh, Jesus. Sorry.
Look, then you need to understand. I'm not even sure what's going on with this. And Anna sort of gestures at herself. But I'm willing to stick it out with you until then. But, you know, if you need help with Les or anything, just let me know, okay? But just between you and I, if my health is in your best interest, maybe consider a few of your actions before you take them.
How so?
What do you mean? I don't understand.
Anna sort of gives her a sideways glance and then says,
come on, tell you what, with what little gold we got, at least the upside, I can buy you lunch. And I don't really have anything else to address.
All right.
I don't really have much more.
I think I've been unfairly painted here.
Okay, well, you weren't there, so don't worry about it.
Two hours earlier. Get in the fucking coffin, bitch! Question. How much was the banknote worth?
It's actually on the loot page.
It's already factored into one of them?
Mm-hmm. It's there. So, the party travels to the central exchange to redeem their banknotes for gold pieces. As you enter the building, shortly after, Ironsides emerges and brings you to his office.
Mr. Ironsides.
To discuss with you what happened with Warren and Stillgate. Well, hello. It's good to see that you've made your way back.
Okay, hold on. Trying to figure out this loot thing. So you said total adventure loot, which is from...
It's everything overall. So if you just want one number, you take that number.
Okay, cool. Because my character sheet already has all my expenses tallied. Sweet. Thank you.
Because I update throughout the adventure and then I do a total at the end. So if you want to update as you go, you can. If you want to do it at the end, it's there too.
I could kiss you.
Why don't you?
I've
offered to blow him before and he just lied.
We're gushing.
Anyway, sorry to interrupt the role playing.
Is Rosemary here?
Rosemary is not here, no.
Okay. Why don't you guys summarize the mission? Because Anna was a mute for like the last month and a half.
You don't really have to go into detail.
Yeah, Gorgon strikes up his pipe and explains the situation and says, we preserve the peace as tenuous as it might be.
I see. It must have been difficult interacting with savages like the gnolls.
Gorgon folds his arms and says, it comes naturally to other savages.
I see. He brings out a bottle of clover and brandy and several glasses and pours a drink.
And then pirates burst through the windows.
Oh, please.
Yeah, sorry, Benzel. They're doing this because you cut out.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. If we start talking about pirates, you're gone.
Oh, okay. I'll just go back to where I was. He brings out a bottle of clover and brandy and several glasses, pouring a drink for anyone.
And then the pirates come. He got
one more word than before. Sorry, Benzel.
We got the brandy shit.
Let's just make sure.
I assume he's gonna pass out some glasses to anyone who wants some brandy.
So next time he cuts out,
Everyone just shut the fuck up.
So Ironsides, he enthusiastically listened to your story and then says, I'm rather surprised the way things.
Son of a bitch.
It keeps cutting out.
Should we try and restart the call?
I guess. I don't really know what it'll do, but.
I think we just got a notification, guys. When he cuts out,
internet difficulties
to come back.
Okay. I'm rather surprised the way things turned out. You certainly met the challenges head on. Those savages so well. Your efforts are commendable. He raises a glass to the party.
I'll drink.
Someone raises her flask.
To Tor.
Gorgon will drink.
Gamery toasts.
Gorgon says to Tor.
To Tor, says Thrindle.
To Torg.
Thunder goes out.
Okay, calm down. Happen to...
That was a little racist.
So, what do you doing now that you're back in Abbotshore?
Gorgon says, well, personally, I need quite a bit more gear, but no direction after purchases have been made, unless anyone else has anything in mind.
Well, I was... maybe we could find my sword now.
Your what? Gorgon says, question.
Yang cries.
Gorgon uses some of your tears for material components for his alchemy.
Ooh, I want some.
If you're in need of some work, I happen to know of a noble lady who owns several buildings in the eastern slums. She needs some work done if you're interested.
Sorry, she owns several what?
Several buildings in the eastern slums. She wants to remove some scoundrels that have set up a gambling den there. They haven't paid any...
Sorry, Gamery's any rent.
Well, I'm not certain if of... how vigorously she wants to remove these people, but I thought that it might interest you.
Michael, I'm surprised you would go this route of intimidation. I mean, is it not best to work through the channels of law and have a lawful eviction?
Oh, absolutely. This is through the law.
Are we acting as sheriffs of sort?
Exactly. It is up to the owner of the estates to run their buildings.
Less nods. Is there any documentation that we can show to them to prove our authority in this matter?
Well, I mean, if you are interested, I would of course set you up a meeting with her with her butler, so you can discuss the details.
I've always been interested in real estate.
Huh. By the way,
become landlords.
Mr. Ironsides, how, if I may inquire, how is Rose doing?
Oh, Rose quite Harry. Well. She's found some work in a manor as a scullion.
I see. What's a scullion?
Who whispered that?
Scullion.
That's
is
my friend, you bitch. Don't talk shit about Rosemary. I'll fucking kill you right here.
It's an entry level position in a kitchen that basically scrubs pots.
Okay,
she's
cool.
A dishwasher.
Yeah. Oh, disgusting.
But some by fucking
day. Gotta start somewhere.
Dishwasher by day.
At a whorehouse because she's too young to hook.
Dishwasher by day.
Jesus God.
Oh, gee. She is a lady. She is a widow. Her name is Lady Harkness.
The girl Rose is working for, or this is our patron? Sorry.
A patron.
This is the woman who he knows of. You could do a knowledge local.
Yeah, can I do that untrained? Like, I'm from Abbott Short, and, you know, Michael Ironsides is like a father to me.
I don't think you can...
Nat 20 knowledge local.
I'm not sure you can do any knowledge as untrained.
If only there was some way to increase your ranks every level.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I have a spreadsheet for that.
You know what's better than increasing your ranks? Rolling an at 20. I just roll an at 20 every time.
I was just wondering if she was possibly part of the circles of my family. If not,
I mean, you've no. you haven't actually heard of her before. You suspect that she's not, for two reasons, because you haven't heard of her before and because of
she's in the slums.
The fact that she owns buildings in the slums, she's probably.
Yeah, Russell, you're probably right about her.
Do. Since you have shown yourselves to be capable, I may be able to find you additional work if I listen. There are always those in need of expertise like yours. I will be sure to let you know if I learn of anything suitable. Anna Rosemary has asked about you. May I give her an address that that she may be able to call upon you at?
Oh, of course. As we've discussed, unfortunately, I'm still just staying at the Blue Boot. But actually, if...
The Gilded Tavern, or whatever.
Is she still staying here with you?
She has been staying with me, but she will be moving out soon.
Oh. I'd be more than happy to meet with her soon. If we don't, if you could tell me where she's staying, perhaps I could meet up with her after we deal with this employment that you've set up for us.
Well, she is staying with me for the time being, but we'll be moving into the manor that she's working at. But I can let her know that you're back in Abbotshore, and she will surely come and see you.
And I just sort of nods in appreciation.
I got a nat 20 on a knowledge local for the woman that owned the buildings.
So, you have heard of her before. She is, as Leslie suspected, not exactly terribly well-to-do, but she is a landowner in the city. Basically, her husband died...
And
because they didn't have any children, she basically took over the estate and seems to be managing it, as it would seem, as she's hiring muscle to evict some rowdier tenants.
Can I give maybe a couple of her like likes and dislikes, like attitude wise?
Likes dick.
She likes fine food. She dislikes impertinence.
Wait, what's impertinent?
Yeah, what do you mean?
It's like being, what's the word to describe that? Too big for your britches, basically.
Oh, it's acting when you're like
too,
me.
Oh, okay.
More or less. Basically, yeah, so not following... Like not following the chain of command, not knowing your station, you know, that sort of
thing.
Insolent.
Okay. So, you spend some time just sort of talking with Ironsides and sharing a drink. And shortly after, he... bank business to get to. So now what we're going to do really quick is we're going to just, if there's anything else anyone wants to do today, we're going to go to the initiative and then they can perform it. And this will include...
I would like to have a little side note with Anna again.
Yeah, you can do that. Well, I'll just do that once your turn comes.
Yeah, but I'm just going to chat it to him. I'm not gonna.
Oh yeah, yeah, no, sure.
Waste more time. That's,
yeah. Well, I'm not reading until your initiative comes up.
Boom, motherfucker.
That's fine.
Materials.
Special so materials. You can do things like train to get an additional car. So if you guys have any, those are still available. If not, you don't have any, obviously.
Sorry, I
At least you cut out for me, Benzel. But did you say you are doing like hero points?
Yeah, I'm gonna continue using those.
Okay.
So if you wish to train, you can do that.
Right.
So yeah, you can just go ahead and roll your initiative when you're.
Oh yeah, it's coming.
Russ and Matt.
Their inside is looking jolly.
Yeah. He's been happy ever since my mom died.
Gave you guys that picture, didn't I?
Yeah. Fun fact, the reason that I made him friends with Warren Gear was that Michael Ironsides was the original picture for Warren until Drew used him, and then I couldn't.
No way.
Yeah. That's why I also.
You have a good taste in photos.
And Drew,
it's also like the third picture that comes up when you search NPC.
Fat
Camry,
man.
You got a roll?
Yeah, NPC. Yeah, put it on the order. Let's test it out.
On the
NPC.
Now.
That's how Russell Googles. He's a wizard costume.
Yeah. He's like, perfect.
I'm like, that'll
That's
do.
Exactly what I saw in my head.
Like, and I love how there was no turnaround with Jimmy. He was just a wizard. Like, it was just.
There was, he was actually he had depth actually beyond his wizard.
I don't believe
of course.
You.
Yeah,
Jimmy.
We just couldn't.
Jimmy's an outsider.
We couldn't. We just didn't pierce the enigma, which was Jimmy, with our questions.
Jimmy is an outsider.
Jimmy's not his real name. He couldn't hold his form.
This is true.
Yeah, this is true. I predicted he was an outsider, but no one would let me get his ilk.
Icker, fuck! How many times?
So,
sorry, not unless they're in the petroleum business.
You have just left the Central Exchange. What would you like to do in Abbot Shore? You could perhaps do some crafting. You could do some training.
I would like to craft.
You could. Okay.
So I'm going to buy.
You can spend your day crafting.
Yeah, I'm going to buy the materials to make alchemist fire.
Carl, do you have any idea what you're doing with the craft?
Do you have an alchemy?
No, I kind of need.
Do you have an alchemist lab by any chance?
I have an alchemy. Yeah, I've got what's it called?
Alchemy kit is actually something different, unfortunately.
What?
So I set myself up.
Benzel, you can do alchemy with artisan tools.
Lies.
It's true.
I guess.
Like, I think artisan tools are just for one specific thing.
Yeah, but you have, it actually says in
usually
one of the alchemy descriptions that you, without, it's actually, I think, under the alchemist lab. I have the PDF on my phone, but I'm just looking something up. I'll
anyways,
let you know.
It's not.
Well, just tell
I
me what I need to buy. I got lots of money.
Being facetious.
The problem is, Carl, with crafting, like, I literally have a spreadsheet that tracks it.
Yeah. Can't
you? Are you willing to commit to that?
I'm going to have to, man. I'm an alchemist.
Well, okay,
said
so
now and never.
You return to probably the Blue Boot, go to your room, begin mixing your chemicals after having obtained what you need to make an alchemist fire. I think that'll take at least. Okay, and now we are on to Anna. Unless,
I don't know how long you said it would take, but if I'm working a full day, can I get one done?
An
probably
alchemist
not.
Fire? Well, no, I don't think so.
It depends
it's
on...
not that fast.
Yeah.
You did roll really well, but I'm not sure. So Anna,
yeah.
Already sort of done a little bit of what you wanted to do already? Anna, are you there?
Sorry, what?
Is there anything else you wanted to do today?
Training? I guess go find Rosemary, I guess. I don't really have anything else to do.
Okay.
Do I still have a horse? I should also go see if my horse is still in the stables.
Hasn't been impounded.
Far horses, yeah, didn't get...
All right. So you return to... in on the edge of town. I believe that's where we left them.
Yeah.
And you go to the stable keeper. He's at first surprised to see you. I mean, For my own memory, what does anyone remember about what we did there?
We probably owe 3 weeks of boarding because we paid for a week.
Well,
to be honest, though, long...
My adventure was like 2 months, dude. Like, it was going there and then
I'm sort of thinking that we probably didn't leave enough
money
to stable them. And after this amount of time, the stable keeper is going to say, I'm sorry, after you left your horses here and that went weeks over what you had paid, I was forced to sell the creatures.
Anna just sort of, you know, she just shrugs and says, I don't suppose I would have expected anything different. You don't happen to have another one of the beasts for sale, do you?
Unfortunately, no. I don't typically trade in horses.
Well,
just stable them.
Spellman's gonna have to murder this guy.
At that, you probably leave. Go and do something else. Maybe you want
go,
to
go find Rosemary.
Fuck off, little girl.
Now.
I'm going to delete all this other stuff from my inventory that was on my horse.
Womp womp.
Get fucked.
You didn't keep my tent, did you? Nah, it's fine. I'm not going to carry it. I'm going to be fucking like crippled and encumbered. So.
No, you're not going to just throw the saddlebag over your shoulder and
put the bit in my mouth.
Yeah.
Actually, we could do that.
You, having spoken to Ironsides earlier, you do learn that she is indeed working, but you wait until after she's.
Yeah, I just hang out. City or something.
And also because you're a little bit concerned about just like entering this manor to speak with a servant.
I wouldn't do that. No.
Yeah, you basically probably just wait outside to see if she exits. And eventually, a slightly bedraggled looking Rosemary does emerge and begins to head home for the day. She looks up and is surprised to see you. Her eyes light up as she sort of quickly runs over to you. Oh, Anna, it's so wonderful to see you.
Anna smiles and says, It's good to see you too, Rosemary. You're looking wonderful.
Thank you. Thank you so much, she says as she begins to sort of fuss and try to like calm down her hair a little bit and straighten herself up.
Right.
Because she's obviously been working quite, you know, putting in some hard work and looks worse the wear for it.
Right. Anna will interject and say, your uncle told me that you were working here.
Yes, it was good of him to help me find a place that I could be my own person. I appreciated him giving me a place to live, but there was nothing to do.
Oh, I understand. Independence is one of the things that's difficult for all of us to gain. I also hear that you're planning on moving out on your own soon, or at least moving into here, and sort of nods towards her workplace.
Yes, typically the servants do live here.
And you like the job?
It's not what I expected it to be, perhaps, but I didn't expect to find so I guess this is one of my only choices.
That's fair, but they treat you well?
Yes, certainly. The other cooks in the kitchen are quite nice. You begin walking down the street as she sort of starts to head home. She questions you about your absence.
And I feel almost like partially a confidant. Like, I think Anna would actually tell Rosemary kind of what happened. Like, not everything, especially I think I would skip the island part, kind of like, or at least sort of like skim around it, but I would probably tell her about that, you know, so like not just being like, oh yeah, we went to some place and nothing happened. Like I would actually, if provided she can handle it, like tell her that.
So she listens intently to your tale and is sort of awestruck by what you tell her. Oh, I wouldn't have thought it was possible to do such things, a girl of your age. A girl of our age, rather. Because she's
Anna smiles genuinely and says, neither would I.
Quite astounding. Well, everything's going fairly well for me here.
And if there's nothing else, I'm going to take her to dinner just because, I mean, I have a bit of gold left, but...
Nice.
I don't have to buy a horse.
After dinner, do you kiss her? No.
why? You have a problem with lesbians, Benzel?
Maybe you could do a spell.
He does,
No, it's completely fine. I mean...
Sometimes I think about two women doing a spell together, and then I do a spell myself.
It's a life choice, right? it's not something that Anna could have been born with. It was a life choice, right? You guys gonna make more gay jokes after I played Ember, huh? Assholes.
I hated that Ember was gay because I was trying to seduce him.
And I'm casting. I'm casting a cure disease on him because he'd just get ungay.
Anyways, yeah.
I'm casting a huge spell right now.
It's only platonic, but I mean, Anna, like if only because, due to the circumstances in which we rescued her, like it is sort of an anchor.
Well,
I guess.
Sort of almost like a guardian almost at this point.
Kind of. But I mean, I also see it cause like, not to get too into it, but like Anna can't really like. Her perceptions of the world compared to everybody else in the party is like so skewed that it's like Rosemary is her sort of anchor to her past life of being like a regular person. So Anna probably like kind of tells her the truth as far as I don't think I would tell her I'm a spellcaster yet unless she's sort of found out on her own.
Not to my knowledge.
But
she listens to you intently and seems genuinely happy to see you and is thrilled, you know, having not having to cook for herself. And after that, you probably just return back to the Blue Boot. Nameless Girl, is there anything specific you would like to do? Some sort of training or crafting?
I'm basically going to be sitting in my room, like kind of practicing my makeup and working on, like, continue my checks with my new costume.
Want to get the other girls for that? You can, like,
makeup parties.
Yeah, we can bring in, like, Anna and Yang.
Yeah, there you go.
Girls, your hair.
There you go.
So you
practice your. Did you want to apply this to anything?
I'm making a new costume so I don't have to pay full price.
Oh, okay. That's cool. Do you have a requisite sort of craft skill? Or?
Yeah, craft clothing.
Oh, wow. You do have it. That's cool. Interesting. You do your check and spend your evening cutting cloth and sewing and practicing.
Oh, no way.
Or disguise.
Poisons are weightless. That's awesome. Yep. I have them down for a pound each.
Anything weightless, I always go 0.1 just to give it something. Gorgon.
Okay, so Gorgon has two items on his list that's not crafting. He wants to buy a mithril chain shirt.
Ooh. What does mithril do to it?
It makes it lighter.
Oh, it's all
gives you gives it a higher dex bonus.
Yeah. So yeah, and also I am currently battling kind of a weight economy issue. So could I just buy one straight off the shelf, or am I gonna have to order one?
You will have to get one made, but it won't take...
or something.
Yeah, because like it's not like everything's, especially with armor, because it's very, very specific to
size your body size.
So yeah, but it won't take very long. Let's say like a couple days, maybe a day or two. So cool. You can pretty well put that on.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Second thing is I want to buy the ingredients for Taggart oil, which is a stun poison.
Okay. For the ingredients for I'm not going to worry about it too much.
The price per dose is 22.5.
Okay, $22. So gold. You're going to spend that on the ingredients.
Yeah. Other than that, I'm just going to roll some craft checks, but I'm actually redoing some of my tables. Because I thought ingredients were 5 gold, divided by 5, but they're divided by 4. So I'm just correcting my table here. But I am good.
Sorry. So,
did you want a list of the stuff we're buying?
Drew, read the chat.
Unless it's like magical or exceptionally expensive, I'm not too concerned about it.
Okay, I'm just buying like disguise kits and like sheets of leather or if and it's cloth not... and stuff.
You know, as long as it's not anything crazy,
what are you
like
talking
you know,
about. I'm
use
reading.
Your discretion.
Yeah. Okay.
Use your discretion. And Gorgon, it's fairly easy to find the chemicals that you need, as apothecaries are quite prevalent in Abbott's Shore, and there is no restrictions on materials. Like it's basically you can buy just about anything, and it's not like there's no regulations or any sort of laws governing that, really. It's just you can buy anything. They're like, oh, you have a headache, here, take a draught of this cocaine sort of thing.
Oh, that won't help.
Well, you know, whatever.
Tired waking up this morning.
Yeah, have some laudanum.
Yeah, and take 2 laudanum tablets and call it a day.
That doesn't help you. I have some mercury pills.
Carl, we're using different crafting rules than the ones Luke pasted.
Yeah, don't use those ones. You'll never figure it out.
Yeah.
So Gamry.
Okay. So Gamry finds himself sitting next to a fountain, looking at his sheath, and he says... He's talking to himself, and he's, like, knocking on his sword, and he's like, you never talk to me anymore.
What's the matter, Gamry? I thought we were best friends!
He's like, I made you this nice sheath. I've killed so many people for you. <He's> like, Gamry's, like, psychotic Down syndrome side comes out.
Svelte and Gamry have a lot in common.
You didn't...
And Anna,
you didn't kill them for me, Gamry. You killed them for us.
Then he's like, what have I been doing? I'm not a knight. He wipes like all this corpse filth off himself. He's like, I need to find myself again. I need the touch of a woman.
That's a good idea, Gamry. Perfect logic, as always.
One phallic symbol to another, Gamry.
By the way, you're a knight to me.
Jesus. Gamry makes an intelligence check to know where he might find women that play music. Or, I guess that's the right check.
Sure.
-1.
Immediately, what comes to mind is a lovely red-haired buxom woman from a little place called Nancy's. Yeah, but there are some other locations that you could probably peruse to find someone to.
Yeah, didn't you like smash her in the ground previously?
Yeah, yeah.
No, I did not. I ripped the loot.
For Gamry, that's just foreplay, though. I mean, let's face it.
She's not over it by this point. I did take the loot forcefully, though.
I mean,
she's probably been assaulted lots, let's face it.
She's a boss.
Maybe I can... I don't know. Gamry's the type to make a fresh start. Rather than...
He isn't, or he is?
You know, he is the type. He's not going to... He's giving up on her.
There it is.
Anyways,
all right. You're right.
Gamry wants to clean up.
I don't know.
She was a betraying bitch.
I don't know if it matters what you think, Russell. It's what she thinks.
What? Oh, I don't know. Gamry doesn't see it that way.
Gamry has a lot of money. So.
You're still on about that.
Anyways. Yeah, I mean, we don't need to go into it too much now, but just say Gamry, like, cleans himself up and goes out to meet people at a...
No, I think we should go into it, like, is
unless Benzo wants to.
Gamry does clean himself up and puts on his smartest outfit, which shines up
armor.
Yeah, basically
he's wearing the same thing, but cleans some of the gore out of his chainmail.
Yeah, he still brushes the front of his armor so it's not as rusty.
Just the back, though, total disaster.
Yeah, exactly. You can tell he's just done it himself while wearing it because it's just the front.
yeah, it sounds about right.
Going to the inn, it's quite packed. You can see that there is indeed musicians there. That it looks like there are several that have been playing or will be playing. Right now, there is a man with a what are those called? The it doesn't matter.
Theremin.
Yeah, he's playing an electric instrument invented in the 1980s. he's playing, or did you say the clarinet?
No, he said theremin.
Oh, he did say the theremin. Okay,
no, you had him.
Clarinet.
You're referring to a lute?
It's playing some sort of woodwind oboe. Instrument. There's a
the oboe.
Yeah, sure. Oboe. Sure.
Get out of there, Russell. Get out of there.
Yes. Can I do? I kill Rosemary and go to this bar.
After a performance or two, a young, beautiful woman takes this place playing a
shitty lute.
An instrument, some sort of horn.
Ooh, damn. Gamry likes women that can blow a horn. yeah, no, he'll Gamry takes like an obvious front row seat and like constantly throws coins into her bucket.
As she's playing and you're sort of sitting front row and throwing coins in, you sort of catch her eye and she smiles at you.
Is this the same one he attacked?
No, this is a different girl.
Oh, yeah.
Is this... Like, I was gonna say, Gamry, this is 50 Shades. Is this a shady establishment? Like, are the girls likely to be multi-purpose, or... is?
Wow.
That was a very politically correct way.
That's what Nancy's was. Nancy's was...
this is on the edge of the slums? So you're asking if she's like a lady of the night?
Ooh, a night walker is also acceptable.
Yeah. That was your question.
Worker. Yeah.
I guess Gamera's wondering if she's a lady of X nights.
Ooh.
High five, Russell.
Yeah, that was good. That was really good.
Gamera was
so
he just lies about it.
It does seem like they have some of those women here. They do stand out from the way they're dressed.
Gamry
wants to approach one of them.
This one, the one playing music. He doesn't want them if they don't play music.
Do you want to wait until she's finished, or do you want...
Yes. Yeah, he'll wait.
Gamry, you got attacked, bro.
After after the performance is finished, everyone gives her a round of applause, and she takes a small curtsy, collects the tips that she has made, and begins heading to the bar. Gamry stands up, straightens himself out, clears his throat, and approaches.
I could kill you, you know.
Gamry's like trying to think of his best pickup line. He's like, oh, fuck, it's been a long time. he's like, excuse me there.
My name. Turns to you and with wide eyes. Oh, hello.
I happen to be a traveler, and I particularly enjoyed your music. I was wondering if you might tell me where you learned to play.
Oh, well, my father taught me.
Sexy.
Ew. Daddy issues.
Ew.
This sounds promising.
He's like, oh, go on. He just buys her a drink and gets right into it.
By the way, I love your shoes.
For some reason, the woman seems terrifying. Sort of...
Oh, yeah. Should I make a check before we shoot me down?
Before you shoot me down. You can roll a nat 20.
Don't be manipulative, yeah. Russell.
You have a big sword.
Oh, damn. Okay. But right.
So, yeah. For some reason, this woman seems to have, like, a fascination with horses and just general... What's horsemanship called? What's that?
Equestrian.
Equestrian, yes. She sort of seems... like is really fascinated with it, and it seems to be something that she talks and it's something that really doesn't interest you.
Gamry's interest
all right, yeah, it does Gamry's interest like, you but all
oh
of
my
your...
god, I used to ride a horse
before they took it away from me.
After I stabbed it in the back.
Yeah,
why
exactly.
Why do you sound like two?
I wrote it into the rats.
Two fucking college girls. Oh my god, I had the best horse before I lost my knighthood.
Now, unfortunately, a lot of your experiences with horses haven't been that nice. So, she sort of seems to pick up on that. Through your conversations, it's not like you're outright saying, oh yes, I rode this horse to death and had to, you know, put it down, but she sort of seems to read between the lines a little bit, and seem as enchanted with you as she maybe was at the beginning of the conversation.
Gamry senses he's losing her, and he just he's like, all right, one last chance. He's like, I'll be honest. I know I'm rough around the edges. I'm a man of the sword. That being said, I'm pretty rich, and I would pay you for
sex. She goes, her face... Here, let me do a check, actually, really quick.
I know it might seem extremely repulsive, but I'll pay to fuck you. Hey, come on, honey. Don't you wish all men were dishonest?
I'm muscly all over.
Let's have you make another check.
Diplomacy. I've had a friend of mine in real life yell that at someone.
How about intimidation do, like, check?
Do some, yeah, any sort of charisma check you would like.
No skills, so.
And then she's going to roll hers. She gets a bonus because this is something that really is not.
She gets a lot.
Yeah, or on, something that she... One. So she basically, she stands up and she throws her drink in your face. Ugh. She says, I'm not that kind of girl. She sort of storms off.
Gamry like grips his sword, but then he's like, not, no.
Gamry, she wasted top quality booze.
Gamry just leaves. And he's like,
before, shortly after the woman,
she's not worth it anyways.
Another much more sort of gaudily dressed woman.
Overheard you say that. Then pirate burst in.
Do we lose them?
She holds out her hand to the barkeep who puzzled look and then eventually hands her his cloth that he was cleaning glasses with, and she begins to dab you off.
Gamry's
like, is there maybe something I could do for you, honey?
Well, I was about to reject you, but you're showing signs of squire skill.
What the fuck?
Oh,
you're
skill?
So crazy.
What kind of duties does that involve? She asks,
polishing my sword.
Let me show you.
Polishing my sword.
Get, all right. I don't want to drag this
up
too
I'm
long,
starting to cringe over here.
I do.
My toes are curling. Just roll okay. I want to hear you guys do it, and then we can move on.
I just want to record you guys having sex, and then we can move on.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically, Gamry's not attracted to women that don't play music, but at this point, he just wants to feel attention.
He's a fucking
He's so interesting.
Serial killer, dude.
So it's like watching an atomic blast. It's horrifying.
Hold
beautiful.
Hold that loot while I fuck you.
He's more of a dirty bomb. Like, he's new.
It's not even that, because then when he had the chance, he's like, just let me hold your hand. Let me hold your hand.
Yeah, he's crazy.
You're like Geralt. You're just a fucking weirdo. Like, what do you do?
Geralt.
So basically, you cut through the nonsense and you spend the evening with them.
No. He'll go to a room with her, but he just wants to, like, play squire.
Okay.
He's like, yes, yes, now kneel before me.
She
kissed the sword.
She goes along with...
That's a two-handed weapon.
You know what I don't pay my squires, right?
His old squire's name? What was his old squire's name again?
What was the guy from
Ernie?
I'm telling you.
Ernie.
Let me call you Ernie.
So yeah, basically that happens. She plays the squire game, and yeah, you leave with a smile on your face, and let's say 20 gold for your troubles.
Gamry doesn't pay squires. It's like,
oh my
so is
God.
That what you're gonna do? You're not gonna pay her when it comes
time? How? I don't know.
It's a role play. She's not your real squire.
Gamry,
Russell.
You should always pay your prostitutes.
All right, Gamry will put two and two together. Actually, no. Intelligence check. Gamry could have actually not known that she was just playing. Wow. Now he figured it out. He'll pay her, whatever. But he didn't realize it till it was near the end.
Oh yeah! Wait a minute, you're not a squire, you're a hooker.
Yeah, or
you are a harlot.
You leave the inn with a smile on your face and slightly lighter gold pitch. To Yang.
So Yang, assuming that the shopping's been done, he's going to probably go to Nancy's to try to ask his favorite information dealer if he has any information on who might have killed that dude that had my sword.
Donovan Matthews,
yes. And
I know that name because I made it up from a hockey player's name.
Yes. Oh, wait, no, you don't know who killed him. That's right. I was thinking that you killed him, but you didn't. You just came in on it.
Yeah.
All right. So, you make your... The slums are not only putrid, but the people in the slums are really sort of disconcerting. They're the type that really, well, belong here for one, but they're really down-and-out people, certainly. And they really add a bad atmosphere to the area. Like, when you're walking through, you actually sort of feel... You know, you would have his hand on his gold, you know, type of thing. He is concerned about that type of thing.
Yeah,
you do make your. Yep, go ahead.
I do also have my hand on my sword at all times.
Of course, but yeah.
I mean, I don't look tense. I'm just casually holding it, but still.
Right, but I mean, you kind of that's sort of your character's thing. Is he's always more or less got his.
Yeah.
No. Sword.
It's always prepared.
Carrying it, right? So yeah, you make your way to Nancy's. You get Lawrence, I believe that's her name. Attention. She says, "Oh, well, hello, Yang. It's so nice to see you. It's been such a long time.
Yes,
what brings you to?"
I was going to say, yes, we've been very busy in the past months. I was wondering if Hubs was around.
Oh, certainly. I'll get him for you. She goes to the kitchen and yells out, Hobbs! And very shortly he emerges and comes out. He sort of gives a hobgoblin greeting to you.
I give him a bow, and I say, greetings, Hobbs. I was wondering if I could ask you, because you seem to be the guy who knows everything around town, if you know maybe rumors or better information on who might have killed Donovan Matthews, because I believe he's the one that had my sword.
Donovan Matthews. Now, you got your information about Donovan Matthews from Hobbs, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
I thought it was you.
Nope. Check.
Really? It wasn't you? You didn't get it? He says, unfortunately, I don't know who killed him. The murder has gone unsolved.
Really?
Do you know anything about it? Obviously not.
No, of course not. Yes. So, do you know perhaps of anybody else who could have information? Anybody who might be interested in that type of item? Any lead that I could possibly follow?
Well, I could perhaps ask around for you and get back to you on that. You were quite liberal with your payment before, so I think I can probably do that for you.
I would truly appreciate. Say, I shall give you 20 gold, and if you come back with valuable information, I will double that amount.
Smile comes across Hobbs' face, and he says, just the type of deal I like to hear, he says, as he extends a hand to you in a shake.
Yeah, sure.
He takes his gold and says, it can be difficult to get specific information outside of Abbott's Shore, but I will be sure to do my best.
I trust that with that payment and the ability that you demonstrated previously, that you will succeed.
That's saying, like, you know, in a nice Yang way. It's not like, better succeed.
Yeah, no, it wasn't. Yeah, no, I definitely got that context.
Cool.
And he's pleased with you. You've thrown him quite a lot of gold, so, like,
yeah, that's the goal.
You know, that's the number one thing for Hobbs is that. And female hobgoblin.
Yeah. So I'll remove 20 gold from my inventory, and I'll
Now, if there's anything else, because that's just like a little RP, if you wanted to do anything else, you're more than welcome to, as you still have more time, of course.
Yeah, so
that would have taken your entire day.
Yeah. Okay then. In that case, how about, because Yang, when he tried to make a portrait of Torg, because it's the first time that he tried to do portrait and he kind of sucked, rolling a nat 1, he wants some practice. So maybe what he's going to do is, just for the day, he's going to set, maybe just a little, maybe not in this district, maybe in a more reputable place, he's going to offer portraits.
Set up your easel. Oh, yeah. Are you going to be like a street portrait person?
Yeah, yeah. Portraits for cheap. Or
you do like charcoal or something? Because
do characters. Profession shags.
Yeah, yeah, basically. And it's going to be like cheap only for charcoal. If you want me to paint it, it's going to be more expensive because it's more time. Yeah,
it's not really. Painting isn't so much a street thing, I wouldn't think, because it's got to dry and et cetera and so forth.
Yeah, that's true.
Never been in Mexico.
So yeah, Chark.
No, I haven't. So you basically set up your easel. Do you want to do it now? Yeah, that's one thing. Do you want to do it in here? How about we switch the map so you can look at Abich? Or
good call.
So yeah, what just district would you like to do it in? And keep in mind, if you do it in, it is possible that you could be sort of not necessarily apprehended, but you know, you're basically busking, right? So
busking without a permit. So where? Because yeah. that part cut out. Where can I not do it? Or
well, the richer neighborhoods may get you in trouble.
I'm being sort of inspecific that
okay,
where so that might happen. It might not be.
I feel the merchant district is probably, I mean, no, merchant district people like, I'm going to go in the Cloverin district. Why not? We've never been there. I want to look a bit at the city. And I feel these people might be more tolerant with like me doing this. Maybe,
you know, that's the religious district, right?
Yeah, sure.
So you head to the Cloverin district.
Quick question. Do potions have weight?
When you arrive there, I always put it as 0.1 just so that it is something and it's not like, I have a million potions and it's not taking any encumbrance. So it's up to you, really. But I always do 0.1 for things without weight. Yeah, exactly, right? I eat all my cheese wheels. Okay, the Cloverin District. As you enter this district, you notice that the streets are much cleaner. There is also much more heavily prevalent religious symbolism with the churches, and the graveyards are actually pretty prevalent as well, which also have gated fences around them usually. You go to a sort of square and set up how would you sort of draw people's attention? Would you simply sit there with the easel? Would you maybe start with a free one to get things rolling? Would you, you know, shout out for customers? What would be your getting?
I would probably be like, write portraits for cheap. And yeah, definitely to get a few examples of what I can do, maybe I would do like...
Do a couple.
A couple for free, maybe to show like here's what you can expect and stuff. Build a portfolio because it's a new thing.
All right, let's do some sort of charisma type check.
Cool. So straight
to start
charisma?
Off with to just sort of to buster some interest.
So that's a straight up D20, and I got a 19, my dude.
So. You're quite lucky, as when you start doing this, a young, quite beautiful woman comes by, and you easily convince her, and you do a portrait of her, and now we'll get you to do a and we'll just do these checks for the whole thing. We'll get you to do a your craft check.
Yeah, sure. I'll roll my painting, craft painting, and I got a 21.
Okay, so you really do draw people in, and because people are sort of more so interested in your work than not, you don't seem to draw any unwanted attention from any sort of officials, and your paintings come out quite well, or your charcoal rather drawings or whatever it is you're doing come out really nice. And there's rules for earning off of your crafting, so you can take that role and put that towards the earning, and we'll actually double the number even because you did so well.
Cool. So
I'm not 100% about those rules. It's under the crafting, so just read that up and okay. Apply that to this situation.
Okay, so double crafting.
not only have you done well with your sort of busking, but you seem to have met a few people as well. So you know, you get a couple names and sort of, so you never know, people might become interested in your paintings and seek you out.
That's kind of cool. Fuck yeah.
All right.
For a vengeance.
Okay, I'm going to roleplay for like a half hour now.
I think it's pretty good.
I think we're done. Okay.
Can I do anything else?
I have a quick question, if I may. I was looking up the price to get something made out of either darkwood or mithril. Basically, I'm struggling with keeping Gorgon's carrying capacity underweight, and I'm looking for ways to cut corners.
Yeah.
Now, I have 5 pounds of... I have 2 sets of tools, and each are 5 pounds each. According to the core rulebook, to make something out of mithril is 500 gold a pound, and anything out of darkwood is 375 gold a pound. To keep that in contrast, to put like my chain shirt, which was 25 pounds, was reduced in weight by half, but only cost 1,000 gold to make. Like, I'm saying, it's too expensive for the tools, but I'd be willing to pay like the 375 to get my tool weight reduced in half.
So. Okay, so you want to make your tools out of mithril, correct?
Yes.
And they weigh how much?
Currently, they weigh 5 pounds. According to the SRD, to make something out of mithril costs... here, just a second. Other items cost 500 gold points a pound, which is ridiculous.
And so you want to reduce price on that.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm kind of iffy about that.
Well, here's the thing, though. Like, if we were using the 500 gold points per pound on the light armor would cost a shit ton more.
I understand that, and I mean, I've sort of tilted at that windmill before, but I don't know. You see, with me and Ebreek and my past experiences, I've just sort of bowed down to it and said, well, I guess I'm not going to get that because it's too expensive. So, you know, I'm one.
Yeah, but
to
just
because
you had a terrible childhood doesn't mean everyone else has to have a terrible
one. I mean, but that's the, like, if you're asking for ruling from me, I mean, that's what I did with myself. So now if we want to sort of decide that as a group, you know, then okay.
But I vote against you.
I was debating fluid ounces, so I wasn't listening.
Same.
Yeah, me too, actually.
you're just looking for weight reduction, so there's maybe something we can do. Why don't we leave it off for now, and we'll kind of...
Okay. Yeah, it's basically... Because, like, the thing is, like, it would give me the carrying capacity for, like, 2 more alchemist fires. You know, like...
Yeah,
you know,
and pain. Really, like... The benefits that you're going to get from the mithril is pretty minor. So,
well, it's because I'd be paying $2,500 just to gain 2 pounds of carrying capacity.
Well,
like, it's
yeah,
not
and
it.
I get that, but like, I don't know. It's yeah, that's the whole thing. Like, and like, it's the same way with adamantium and all those things. The prices are they don't always make sense. So,
yeah,
I don't know. I'll have to think about it. Well, yeah, but. I can't make a ruling like that on the fly. And
that's no problem. How about we put it in the forum so we can talk about it over the week? And by we, probably cool. You, me, maybe Lamat if he feels up to it. Beard will chime in.
Sure. Yeah, what? No.
Okay. Didn't you do something, Leslie? Oh, yeah, you did your crafting.
I crafted, but, you know, that took one roll. Whereas everyone else got to do stuff.
Yeah, if you want to, like, if there's
oh,
any...
Oh, easy
like,
vibe, I also just crafted.
You got questions.
What you chose to do.
Yeah, but I didn't do anything because I don't know how to craft, and, you know, the rule is way over my head. So
if there's
anything...
So is there anything else in the city you would like to do, Carl?
Yeah, I just whispered you two things.
Yeah, okay, we can do that.
Oh, Benzel, so, I need you to update my map.
Yeah, it looks real good.
It looks real sharp.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Thanks, guys.
It's better than my MS Paint Butch job.
Okay, well, after I've done that stuff, I don't want to do anything until the following day.
Does Carl's voice sound like he's...
Why do you sound like Buffalo Bill right now?
Oh, well, I'm Carl. Yeah.
Tell me to put the lotion in the basket.
So Carl, there's this thing you wanted to do. Now, if you want to sort of keep this, you know...
Yeah. Yep.
Do you want to, like, straight up RP that? Or, like, how do you want to go about this?
No, I don't need to RP it.
Because if you do, I mean, we're doing it in front of everybody else, so...
No, I don't need to RP it. I just want to... I can, like, give you rolls if you want. Or whatever.
Yeah.
Or I don't know if I can take 10 on anything.
Like,
yeah, you can, absolutely.
Alrighty. Well, that's all I'm going to do today. The rest, everything... Yeah, that's pretty much that.
If there's any other little additional things someone would want to do because they didn't feel they got enough time, you can go ahead right now and we'll do that. Anybody?
I'm satisfied with what I did because I decided what I wanted to do.
Fuck you.
Okie dokie. Okay, so everybody returns back to their respective places where they hang their cowls and rest.
I was thinking of switching up to more of like a cowl type.
Yeah, could be the gray fox.
I don't know who that is.
Good reference.
Yeah, Holmes. I thought Metal Gear Solid at first.
Okay, so. You may so those of you that make your way back to the Blue Boot Inn for the evening, when you arrive, the place is quite lively. There is a team of dogs and several scruffy men with long staffs. And Harold, the owner, is also there. They are rooting around in the inn, moving furniture, some of the paneling, and they're in the basement, and basically what they're doing is they're killing rats. They're trying to rid the inn of any vermin they can.
Better kill
one of the men moves a piece of wooden paneling and hoots as two rats jump out and run for the exits, but the dogs quickly pounce on them and shake them violently. And then begin yanking on the rats, trying to tug them away from each other. Hey, hey, the man shouts, and the dogs drop the dead rats.
We're in the slums.
After set up, well, isn't the Blue Boot in the financial district?
Oh, it's right. In the merchant district, yep.
In the merchant district, right. I forgot, yeah. The next day... So after settling down for a hearty or light meal, respectively, you retire for the night. The next day, you awaken to a letter from Ironsides instructing you to come to his residence this afternoon to meet with Mr. Bailey.
A quick question for you, Benzel.
Yes.
Have you thought about those mithril prices yet? I'm just fucking with you. It's all good.
I think maybe double. No,
No, I'm just fucking with you.
Yeah, we'll have to see. It's a reasonable argument, but yeah, to give accurate prices, I'll have to think about it. Next time, you'll wake up to a letter from Ironsides instructing you to meet with one Mr. Bailey.
Okay.
Unless there's anything.
Yeah, I'm good. Are you guys good?
Yeah,
sure.
Okay, we're going.
I'm sure. So you arrive early at Ironsides' home. Not too grand, but a respectable estate. Dark-haired young man in servant's clothes answers the door, and brings you into the home. Ironsides greets you as you enter his study. How do you do? He says.
Hello, Michael. How are you?
I'm
doing quite well. Are you? So you're. You are indeed interested in taking this job from Mr. Bailey. He will be here soon.
Absolutely. It's nice to have some honest work. Of course, once you know
more details, of course.
Of course.
You pass the time with Michael for a time before Mr. Bailey shows up. Ironside introduces you and quickly gets down to business. Mr. Bailey says, you see, the problem is these ruffians do not respect Lady Harkness's authority since her husband has died and she is taking over his holdings. It is within the lady's right to remove them from the building, but she does not have the manpower to do so. This would be where you come in. He sort of eyes up Gamry and Gorgon and says, you seem well suited to the task. Does getting your hands dirty worry you?
Les glances at Anna.
Gorgon takes a drag from his pipe and says, he says, depends on the circumstance. I'm not going to kill a man outright in cold blood.
I will.
Absolutely not. We wouldn't expect you to. Although, if these dregs were open to discussion, we probably wouldn't have had to come to you in the first place. If you can find a peaceable solution, then that would be in everyone's interest, but they may not agree to anything like that.
Gorgon says hobgoblins are known for their persuasion and social skills.
Are they?
Oh, God, no.
He said, no, that was an attempt at a joke. Was that funny?
Oh, yeah.
I
subverted your expectations, which my research shows is humorous. Did you find it so?
No, because I simply assumed you believed
at the drawing board.
Because I believed you. I believed. Journal. I thought you believed that you were saying something truthful.
But if I said it with sarcasm, then it would not be funny. You would feel like punching me in the face.
You have no change of tone. You always sound required? Exactly the same.
Huh.
Quite hilarious, Gorgon, says Thrindle.
But you didn't laugh. That sounded.
You know, cool. Elves don't laugh.
My people consider your people way too jovial, Thrindle.
So, Mr. Bailey takes out a map and circles an area. This is where the building is. I can take you by there to show it to you. Would you like to get down to business this evening, or do you require time to prepare?
I think we should set off for this in the morning.
Is the place that he circled Nancy's?
Oh, no.
Okay, sorry. I saw the number one and then the circle, and I was
Nancy's isn't there.
Okay.
That was actually awesome. A mistake. It's actually over here. It's a good thing you said that.
All right.
Less pipes.
I mean, it would have been an interesting conflict of interest.
Yeah, hey, Nancy. GTFO.
We're here to kick you out.
So does anyone need to prepare? Are you good to there?
Carl wants to postpone.
Why do you want to wait till tomorrow?
Is it a new day?
Yes.
He's going to like poison Sveldna again or something. I think we should just leave.
oh, shit. It's a new day.
It is a new day.
Well, then never mind. Let's go.
It's about midday. All right. So he explains to you that these men think that they're sort of obviously above whatever deals they were put to for the rent of the building. And of course, it is the death of the husband, which is really put things.
Yeah, they don't respect the woman's authority.
Yeah, and although it isn't, and Mr. Bailey also explains, although it's not her who deals with them directly, it's Mr. Bailey. They sort of view her as the authority, basically. Also, when she found out that they were using the establishment for gambling and unsavory activities, she wanted to just have them out of there altogether. Of course, they weren't willing to leave, so that's why you guys are.
Gamery comes in. Any prostitutes who plays instruments in there?
27 and my DC okay. is 15. Oh, that's sweet. That's one thing of Taggart oil. I need to roll a second alchemy check here, Benzel.
Okay.
Craft alchemy. Great. Good roll, Drew.
Yeah, good check.
Good check. Okay. So, overnight, Gorgon crafts a thing of Taggart oil and then converts it into a Taggart oil grenade.
Okay. Cool. All right. So, let me see here.
Holy shit.
Jesus, what's that?
Dude, calm your fingers.
So, you make your way to the slums.
Tell you what, Benzel. If you let me have my mithril tools, I'll start using the 0.1 system.
0.1? It's really... Really, yeah. That weight bit, it's really up to you. I mean, you know.
I am 0.5 weight away from my medium load. It's pretty dicey.
It just seemed ridiculous to me to have
Can you hold my drink?
Number of items yeah. that are weightless, you know. Anyways. So, you make your way to the slum district. As you're traveling, you hear a shout come from down the street. Sir Gamery, Yang, Anna. You turn to see that it is none other than George calling out to you.
Who the fuck is George? Oh!
George.
The rat guy?
No, that's Ralst.
Who's George?
The guy we turned from a
oh,
rat?
Oh, yeah, that dude.
Yeah, Matt the rat forgot. Guy.
He was your NPC.
Yeah, that's...
I know.
Sir Gammer Young, you turn to see that it is George calling out to you. He is leading a mule with a cart that is filled with barrels. His face is red and puffy as he approaches you, stopping to catch his breath. How do you do, sirs?
I'm a woman.
It's French plural.
And ma'am.
That's better. Good, and how are you, George?
I'm doing well enough. I say things have been off for me. His eyes look beyond you for a moment in a sort of fixed stare. It's the rats. It terrifies me. Oh, also, he sort of takes you aside for a moment to try to not say this in front of Mr. Bailey.
Right.
Where was I? It's the rats. It terrifies me to think of that life, losing myself as that creature.
Well, you were a very handsome rat.
That's not true.
He snaps out of his state and looks at you. It's little condolence.
I can only imagine how frightening it must be to find oneself in a different forms and not have being helpless.
We wouldn't have left you like that. We're heroes.
Well,
so, and I thank you endlessly for what you did for me, but those memories, they haunt me. And what's more, the rats in the city, there's been so many. People have gone missing. I've seen the big ones. I swear I've recognized one.
Recognize them?
Anna's gonna look at everybody else.
Yeah, Gorgon's
kind of
Gorgon looks at Anna, knowing that she speaks Dwarven as well, and says, do you think it's Ralst?
Like in Dwarven? Anna says, I'm more worried about insert old woman's name here that I don't remember.
Why are you doing this?
What old woman?
What are you saying? Why are you speaking in a strange tongue?
The witch.
Yes, it's not very... It's not very polite. What are you doing?
I am talking to my best friend, Anna Yang.
Well...
Anna's going to turn to you guys and...
Anna and I are friends. We have declared our friendship.
She'll say to George, you're safe now, George. It's not going to happen again.
He dries the perspiration from his forehead with a hanky.
What are you doing away from Nancy's?
He indicates the cart with the barrels in it. Oh, I'm bringing a delivery, of course. Did I lose you guys?
Nope.
Okay.
What are you delivering? Is it mundane and a delivering... waste of time?
Yes.
All right.
Hell.
Does he have, like, or the casks of ale that are on his ship?
Cart.
Land ship.
Or do they have like a valve on them?
The tap?
No, they have.
Are they tapped? No.
No.
No, so you wouldn't tap a keg and movement.
I'm a little confused. Is he going into the building we're trying to clear out?
No, this is just on the street.
We just ran into
street. All right, sorry.
Yeah, he just like saw you on the street. Yeah.
It's like when I go to the grocery store with my dad in Huntsville.
Yeah, exactly.
Like 3 hours to fucking get out of there.
Yeah,
exactly.
That sucks.
I mean, yeah, I don't have anything else to say to George.
Get over it, bro.
He seems a little sort of indignant by your response. Farewell.
I mean, I don't say that.
I didn't actually say
just,
get over
Anna
it.
Anna just sort of stands there awkwardly.
Hey, no reneging. You guys are in chat. You got to be in character.
That clearly wasn't.
Yeah,
Anna's
I told
voice.
You guys this isn't WrestleQuest. No joking around.
Oh, okay. So Gorgon was standing out on the street screaming to this guy, "I want a mithril shirt!" over and over again.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. Give me a shirt.
As long as we're staying consistent.
Yeah.
No, Anna consoled George saying you're not going to go back there, and then sort of like looked at the rest of the group and is like, well George, we have our own job to get along to.
Very well.
Although
I thought it would be prudent to mention what I had seen to you.
What did he see?
Good day.
I truly appreciate
it. It's a good thing you guys listened. He said that he saw...
Fucking Carl.
Saw a rat, and he swears that he recognized one of them.
Notice the theme of rats.
But he also seemed traumatized. I'm going to go ahead and do a sense motive to see, like... Because I imagine he's freaked out. Like, I get that.
He's
but,
just crazy,
well,
man.
Basically, he has all these memories of living a life that he more or less didn't have control of. So it's left a scarring. And can you imagine living
what
as a rat?
What a pussy!
That's
what Yang said. He's like, yeah, that must suck.
I also agree with him. But that's why I'm not taking a lot of credence to his whole. I recognize one of them. Like maybe.
Yeah, he could be slightly hysterical.
That's the only reason possible. I didn't say anything.
Yeah. Yang would. Probably.
Your sense motive, I mean, he seems earnest, but at the same time, he does seem dismayed and, yeah. He does seem like he's been stressed out.
Does it seem to be, like, wrecking him? Or he's, like, I mean, he's still he's working, so, like, he's living a life.
Yeah, he's still working and stuff. He is, perhaps, he looks tired, a little worn, perhaps slightly pale. But, So he says good day to you and heads off in the direction of Nancy's establishment. It isn't very long before you arrive at the gambling den in question. It's quite obviously a seedy establishment. The door isn't even, it's off its hinges and hanging ajar. The building is in pretty bad disrepair. As soon as you enter, they don't have an actual, like, bar, but several tables there where the barkeep is pouring drinks. As you enter with Mr. Bailey, he speaks with the barman and says, I need to speak with, I just need to get that guy's name. I need to speak with Pike. And the barman says, you already know what his answer is going to be. He's not going to pay you. We're under Hazard's protection now. Says, I'd like to hear it from him, from Pike himself, Mr. Bailey says, and sort of disregards the man and begins heading downstairs.
He indicates, are we left alone, or are there like people in the gambling den?
There is. Looking about the room, there are people playing cards here, as many of them seem intoxicated. What was the drug that you invented, Drew? What was it called again?
There was a couple. I don't think I invented any, but there was Flaylee.
Oh, you didn't?
It's the mild one. There was Zerk, Shiver.
Shiver, I think that's the one. It looks like they're selling Shiver here as well, as it appears that there are some people at the table using it.
Gorgon looks at the... looks around at his companions.
Mr. Bailey.
I guess I'll follow Bailey.
Signals for you to follow him downstairs.
Okay.
And look, I did the right thing.
I will follow Bailey.
Karma point?
Hero point. Yeah.
I'm actually going to take one hero point from Carl and give it to you.
Yes. No. Suck it.
I'm literally
Suck
in
it.
The negative now.
Suck it.
Carl, because you rolled a nat 20, I'm going to get you to re-roll it due to your negative hero point. And you're still short one hero point.
I mean, if you consider the fact that he shoved somebody in a Knight and Maiden, it's fair enough.
Okay, first of all, he was already fucking dead. Second of all, I saved
I only finished bushing him.
I did what had to be done to save us.
I make it go faster.
Carl, you're minus one karma point and plus one evil power point.
All right, fine with me.
EPP.
Yeah.
You all, as much as you don't want to admit it, I did what had to be done to save the party.
Whatever
you're right about one thing, I'm not going to admit it. So we head downstairs.
Yeah, I'm just getting all these tokens ready, set up here.
If I get 5 karma points, can I trade Anna for Garibaldi?
Gamry, something. Yep, you can do that.
Want to play Garibaldi? Can you do that voice?
Gamry,
it's me.
Something's wrong with your health there.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it's not quite right.
He's going to take Garibaldi and he's going to go, I fucking kill myself. And he's going to kill himself.
I wouldn't do that. If I can be Garibaldi.
No more Garibaldi.
I am now the most popular NPC.
Smeltna, you're not in vampire mode, are you?
No.
That's lame as shit.
Vampire mode, dude. Shh.
I think it I
forgot to show you my picture of Mr. Bailey.
Yeah, we didn't see Bailey.
Mr. Bailey.
Well, there you go. He looks like a gentleman.
That's the guy who answered the door?
No, that's the guy we're working for.
Yeah, he's basically the butler.
Oh my god, they're having a rat fight.
Oh, Jesus.
So, you enter the basement and there's carousing going on, quite a bit of drinking. It's rather loud. And yes, you can hear shouting as the men stand at the edge of a pit where it appears from this vantage point, it looks like there's a dog in there killing rats.
Oh.
Is it the same dog?
What do you mean? Oh, it from earlier? Like?
Yeah.
Is that what you mean? No, yes. It's definitely a different dog altogether. Yeah.
So perhaps we should mingle before we shut this down.
Gamry, stay on target.
Want to rub shoulders with your own kind, Gamry?
So, Mr. Bailey, unfortunately, I don't have a token here for him. Goes over and walks and speaks to one of the sort of rougher looking gentlemen. He says, "I wish to speak with Mr. Pike." The man sort of laughs at him and walks off. A short while later, returning with a man.
I thought he was just going to walk off, just laughs at him and walks off.
We're just like, ah, fuck you.
Then we just stand there for half an hour. I don't think he's coming back.
Is disabled device Dex, or is it
Int? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I had it set to my Int. That's why it's low.
It's whatever your highest stat is, Drew.
What?
Joking. Hobgoblins can roll twice and take whatever is better.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And they can take your mom.
So when Pike enters and is speaking with Bailey, you can see that some of the people around the bar seem to have it seems to have gotten their attention. Also, it appears that the dog has killed all the rats in the little arena, and
that's a good dogo.
It has lost people's interest. So, Mr. Bailey goes to Pike and says, "You know what we're here for? We require your rent, or else myself and these men here will remove you from these premises." Pike smiles and sort of laughs a little at Mr. Bailey's claim and says, "Really? It seems to me that you're outnumbered here. Looks like go ahead."
Spellman starts in, cracking her knuckles. She's always like trying to crack them as audibly as possible.
Les says, "Count again."
I did it. You and all it's over. Still the same amount.
Sorry, where is Mr. Bailey? I don't. Is his token the one right in front
of us? I actually do not have his token here.
Okay, all right.
So this is like a random bum?
Yeah, there's just patrons here. We'll use this token for now.
Shoot him.
Okay, I thought that was Bailey beside me.
Oh, do we have the like authority to go full lethal on these people?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Yes, you do. But although they're shooting for something that's not like they're not like, "Yeah, just go and massacre all these people." They do want you to try to
be like, they'd rather have their money.
But it's survivors.
If I understand, we are like legally in the right, so it's
correct. If this goes down, the authorities, well, A, they won't care so much because it's the slums, but B, you do have the authority. And yeah, if any authorities now, and of course, Mr. Bailey made this clear beforehand that it was within your rights and legal.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. And sorry, Gorgon wanted to say something.
Gorgon says to him, he cracks his knuckles and says, "All right, lad, you've had your fun. It's time to pay you the piper what you're owed. Otherwise, you'll be teaching me a lot about human anatomy. Is it true your penises can survive severed from your bodies for several minutes? I'm sure I can get some entertainment out of that with your out of that and your dog." And here's this intimidate.
Oh, even Gamry's fucking cringing at that one.
20, not natural.
What do you do versus intimidate? Is it a DC? I'm not 100%
on it. Yeah, it is. It's
like it a HD thing? Or some shit.
Yeah, it's 10 plus their HD plus their wisdom mod, I think.
Okay, so so Pike looks sort of taken aback by Gordon's comment, and sort of tries to maintain his sort of cool, rough demeanor, but it seems obviously shaken, and says, "What am I supposed to be scared of? Two girls and a couple elves?"
Gorgon says, "I'm enough reason to fear One Eye."
Which one said the two
Tell
girls
me, would
comment?
You like to wind up on the street with One Eye begging with the others?
That was Pike. That was Pike. Can you see? Oh, I might not have it.
So oh, I thought this was Pike. Is that
no? Oh, you know, no, that's not him. Sorry.
Oh,
here,
sorry.
Make it so you can
that's
see
okay.
the token.
His penis has one eye. You can cut that one off.
Ooh, that's a
right
good one.
There he is.
Can I get a photo?
His penis.
Well, I don't want to fight him. He looks scary. Less leaves.
Okay.
Gorgon says, "It looks like you're making a lot of gold. What good is it if you're not alive long enough to enjoy it?"
Says that may be true. We are making quite a bit of gold here.
Then pay the landlady.
Tell you what. How about we cut a deal? I'll pay you half of what I owe the woman.
Take the money.
And we'll call it even.
Gorgon says, he looks over
acceptable.
At the dog pit and says, I bet that dog would, he's like, he looks around at the crowd and says, "You're a gambling type. How long do you think it will survive on its own?" There's a common hobgoblin myth that it survives after severance.
Does it look like Bailey is willing to accept that deal?
Oh no, Bailey, when he mentions that, Bailey, says completely unacceptable.
Okay. That is not acceptable. We have given our word already.
I mean, if you are interested in this, you could perhaps lose this Mr. Bailey guy in a sewer or something, perhaps. Maybe we could even do it for you.
We've already given our word. Our honor is on the line.
Gorgon says,
He sort of scoffs at that.
"You look like a gambling man, Mr. Pike, but you don't realize that I'm all or nothing. Is that one funny, guys?" And he looks back. "Anyways."
Rindle nods, very
pay
funny.
"Pay what you're owed."
And he says, "Or else what?" And he sort of looks around to his men who seemingly have their hands on their weapons.
"Or else
Gorgon does a sleight of hand on his pistol, and he's going to point it through his coat right at the guy's dick.
Oh, jeez.
I want a sleight of hand to get my hand on a bomb.
Bomb, 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 bomb.
You cannot sleight of hand a bomb.
Oh, really?
You.
Well, how about that?
Well, you kind of have to like mix it and stuff, I guess. Eh?
Yeah, I have a special feat that lets me use alchemy as a weapon for the purpose of weapon feats.
What's that feat called?
It is actually an archetype called the Underground Chemist.
That's cool.
Is everybody on there? Did I miss someone?
Oh, I'll add my...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think I got everybody.
What's going on? Are we fighting?
Well, I think...
Yeah, well, Gorgon's going to shoot him, so...
No,
yeah.
Gorgon's going to threaten to shoot him.
Pointed a gun.
Oh, I thought you...
No, it's inside his coat. They can't see the... They can't see...
That's what the sleight of hand check was for. Like, basically, Gorgon would put his hands in his pockets, but it's on the trigger of his gun.
Time to kill some fucking cunts.
Oh, we're holding on the initiative. It's his versus my sleight
of
hand.
I always just close it, always, so. It's like a reaction. Wow, Thrandall goes first. No, not really.
I rolled a 19, and I know... Is your Nish plus 4, Thrindle?
No, it's plus 2.
Don't disrespect him.
No, I he doesn't really actually go first. Okay, I think everybody's on there. Yep, looks like it. Okay, Gorgon. Are
Gorgon,
you going
to... Gorgon's anything? Not firing. He's just got his hand on his concealed weapon. That's funny, because of what he's going to do. I'm just looking for my... I don't have an updated sleight of hand on your thing. That'd be plus 12. Plus 12. Okay, so roll his perception.
Okay, just a moment. I gotta see what that is. His perception is plus 0. Versus 28.
So he has no idea. Yeah. Gorgon's holding a gun on the inside of his coat and is prepared to shoot through it into him. So Gorgon says, come on, Pike. Pay your full amount and we'll be on our way.
You're making more than enough money.
You should Pike learn says, to... I've gotten... Sorry, go ahead.
You should learn to pay what you are owed. It will avoid you much trouble, and people will respect you more.
Listen, the old widow doesn't know what she's doing. This place is going to be owned by Hazard any time anyways. If you're really... I've got an offer for you. Why don't you take what I've offered you and get out of my place?
Gorgon says, all or nothing, chump. And besides... if Mr. Hazard's the real money behind it, why am I not talking to him?
Oh, Hazard isn't the money here.
If Hazard's the real...
Haven't you ever heard of a business relationship?
It sounds to me like...
I suppose that hasn't made its way to those hobgoblin countries yet.
Oh, should we get racy?
Gorgon... Gorgon says, you're a tough man, are you, Mr. Pike? I'm afraid hiding behind Hazard won't do you any good. Didn't his compound burn down? Didn't he lose a lot of drugs in that fire?
Oh, you mean the one that happened months ago?
Yeah.
It should, yeah.
I don't know about it, really.
So... I just like to say one thing, you know, since you're a man of business, doesn't it make more sense to pay your rent and keep making money rather than lose everything right now? Because if we apprehend this property from you, everything that's currently in it goes to the landlord. You're not leaving with anything.
And also you will probably die. Yes.
I'm fixing to keep this place and my money.
Which guy is talking to us right now?
It's a red dot. Pike.
That is impossible.
Ah, red dot. You're getting a blinding bomb.
Well, I have my readied weapon trained on him. It says, Pike, this is your last chance. Pay the full amount owed and listen to reason.
Looks like an attack.
Can you guys throw down your perceptions real quick?
Yeah, give me a second. I'm good at percepting.
12.
23.
22. Okay, highest is 22 and 23.
High five, yay!
So, less... And Yang, you see that a couple of these people, this man, and where's the other one? This guy over here appear to have hidden pistols and are ready to... They're, you know, looking like, you know, they've sort of got their guns under their tables or in their coats or whatever.
I'm going to...
It, what you think is guns, it appears. Anyway.
Okay, so I'm going to attempt to whisper that into Gorgon's ear. Do I roll a stealth?
I think Les is going to say, Gorgon, do it.
I don't know if Les saw Gorgon's. Gorgon's got a pretty good concealed weapon. But, let's do Yang's action because he spoke first as well.
Yeah, true enough. What was your sleight of hand?
So you want to whisper.
Do we share any common languages, Yang? Do you speak undercommon?
I think nope. That there's just like a straight up perception DC versus whispering, I'm pretty sure. So
or
you could do it that way.
You know
way.
You speak Draconic and so do I.
What was your sleight of hand, you Gorgon?
Could do that. You could speak a different language or you could do an innuendo. So it's up to you what of those three options
well,
you
I
wish
can say
to
in Draconic.
26
those
actually.
Yeah, okay, hold on. I'm right. Talking to Yang here, not
oh,
like
sorry.
Just hold on.
So sorry, innuendo? Is that a skill or
it's a check you make with bluff?
Okay, so I could
you go. Bluff versus sense motive, but everybody will get to do a sense motive. The whispering, everybody will get to do a perception check. With the language, basically, if people have that language, they'll understand it.
Okay, so I don't know exactly what languages we have in common with Gorgon, because apparently...
We would have discussed that. I speak Draconic, Undercommon, Hobgoblin, and Dwarven.
Oh, Gorgon's perception
again,
was 26?
But I could just speak
26?
Draconic, rather than this stretching so long.
Yeah, no,
sorry. It was my sleight of hand was 26. My perception was the
okay
23.
So I'm probably gonna go. Well, let's see. What's higher? Bluff is 4. Let's just use bluff because I feel that this is a speech thing. It's probably better. So what I'm going to say is I'm going to say, how am I going to say it?
The three with the green dots have guns. Right, I imagine like all those people have.
Again, I'm
faces.
Not trying to steal thunder, but I could. My character could just say it in Draconic. It would be just done.
Okay, well, it's too late. I'm acting
so
first. It's a thing. It's a thing that happens. So, basically, what Yang will say will be, "Careful, Gorgon. Some of these men are staring at us quite intently. That's bad."
They have guns.
It's just that they know that you know, so it's not... could be worse. Let's put it that way.
The one thing they don't understand is I've got one, and no one else knows that. So Gorgon says... Gorgon says, tell you what, let's do a wager. 100 gold.
Pike looks slightly interested. What kind of wager do you have in mind?
Remember that game I suggested that he pulls the trigger?
Okay. Roll your stuff.
So that's 12 versus flat-footed and touch.
Oh, yeah, because it's a gun. Yeah, I guess that is a hit.
Okay, so that
you'd
is...
have to have... That would... That pretty much... stymies everything, doesn't it? Like there's
except
basically...
for deflection. Yeah.
Deflection? Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, it's flat-footed. If they're flat-footed, they don't get
deflection.
Oh, I guess yeah. Yeah, I meant I was thinking like deflect arrow.
Dodge, right? You're thinking of maybe.
So 12 damage to his crotch.
Shot him in the balls.
So... He wasn't kidding.
Gorgon.
So he
hobgoblins have a terrible sense of humor.
Pike howls in pain as Gorgon shoots him.
And that was
second
my
specified
round.
Crotch shot. This campaign.
All right, Les's turn. Sorry, what was that, Gorgon?
Surprise round.
Is it surprise round? Well, you don't really have them. No, it wouldn't be. But you'll still get, like, of course, sneak attack on anyone that you're higher in than the initiative. But so you could
because,
you
well,
get full action.
It's going to move through the initiative before I get back to it. Like, that was kind of my ready surprised attack.
Yeah, you're not going to get extra actions, no.
Okay.
less.
So he got shot in the dick. He has a gun. He has a gun. He has a gun.
Mm-hmm.
We don't even know who's all gonna. Les is going to whip a bomb, a blinding bomb, at this guy, and then he will sculpt it to hit him as well. So this is touch attack, of course. Ever seen a grenade before? Trust me, it's a grenade. 12 touch. It's mine's delayed. 15 touch and 11 damage. And
the DC is
14.
So that's minus 2 because you're in your second range category. So that would make it 13. Let me just check his armor.
His armor!
13. Touch is a hit.
Thank God. So it's 11 damage to him. And then, is it? It used to be 4. Is it 7 now? How does it work for the second guy? Now there's 2 bombs.
No, it's 5.
5? Okay. So it's 5 damage for him, 11.
I'll BRB. 3 seconds.
And DC 14 will save. Is it on both of them or just one?
Just the main person you hit.
Okay.
Oh, the people on the radius don't get Will or Ray Foxes?
I thought it did something to them. I think it stuns them, dude. It dazes them.
Why? Do you have like a special bomb or something?
Yeah, they're blinding bombs.
Yeah, he's doing a blinding bomb.
I thought I had.
So what did they roll versus? It would be a fortitude.
It's a fortitude. It's 14 DC. What is it? I thought I had it on my.
So he passes.
Okay, so he, in the splash area, if they fail, they're dazzled.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so that guy has to roll as well.
Do they, do they still take the damage?
Yep.
From, okay. This guy's gonna roll.
So it's 11 damage, 5 damage. Yay, he's dazzled.
Les throws a bomb at the man in the well, he's not really in the corner. At the
wall.
Man concealing a pistol, which explodes, sending this man flying forward and across the table, landing on the ground, seemingly not moving. Thrindle's turn.
Sorry, who is the one laying on the ground not moving?
This guy.
Oh, okay.
The big X.
I like how he fucking... who cares about casualties?
Thrindle really doesn't want to cast magic here.
Do you want an unloaded pistol? You can grab one from Gorgon.
Why, you have more than one pistol?
No, you can have the one he just shot.
Oh,
you said it unloaded.
No, I'm Thrindle is going to pass his turn. He's going to aid another someone.
Yang. Sweet, sweet, sweet. So I'm going to do a 5-foot step, and I will do a finally double attack on Mr. Pike.
Okay.
So at first, I will hit him with my scabbard. So that is... That's a nat 20. To confirm is 9, so probably not a crit.
So that's obviously a hit. 9 is not confirmed. 3 damage.
And then after I hit him with my scabbard, I unsheath my katana, and I slash the fuck out of him. So unfortunately, it's probably going to be a miss, because it's only a 7.
So... Yang walks up and surprises the man by striking him across the face with his scabbard and trying to slash at him.
Yeah.
All right, their turn.
If he's not holding a weapon, it was flat-footed AC. Oh, maybe for the confirm it could work. I don't know. Probably not.
He does have his sword.
Okay, so that, no.
So Pike, enraged, slashes at Gorgon.
I did shoot him in the dick.
Yeah, I was going to say, there's no way he's attacking me.
No, that's a miss.
And he shouts, get him!
spitting up blood.
So
Pike, no matter what happens at the end of the day, you will be the man with no dick.
This guy shoots at Gorgon. 17.
Now, it's a pistol, right?
Correct.
So that's touch.
Yeah.
So that's a hit, unless he doesn't have precise shot.
Yeah, he does.
Okay,
it's only one damage, though. So. Cool.
I'll take my point of damage.
This guy is going to... The second guy is going to fire at Yang. It's probably a hit.
Yes, it is.
So he fires and hits you in the midsection with a musket ball.
Yikes. So how much damage do I take?
8.
Oh.
You should flex your solar plex and shoot the bullet back at him.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
This guy walks to here and attacks Yang. He is going to attack him twice. He might as well.
He did move.
Yep. He's got 2 weapon fighting.
Ooh. Oh, wow.
Bring it on, bitch!
So the first attack is a 13. That's not a hit. Second attack is a 19.
That is a hit.
So he does 5 damage as he slashes you with a short sword.
By the way, for your offhand, you only had half your strength bonus, so that could be slightly less damage.
I don't think that these guys had strength.
Maybe.
Or no, they must have, because they did. Here, I'll look at the stats real quick. See if there's something off.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I don't know. That's weird. I mean, I pulled these stats off of the SRD, so I'm just going to keep rolling with them.
Sure. I mean, okay.
if you're not prepared. The damage is less on the attack.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So that was...
I mean, that's why I care.
It's two less damage.
Oh, cool. So I'm going to heal up to 20. Hey, it matters, dude.
let me just...
True hit points do matter.
Real quick.
All hit especially points at matter. Low levels.
Okay. Let's get back to this. Okay, this guy walks over to Shveltna and attempts to stab him with a
dick.
Whoa. Dagger. I don't even have my shield out, bro. That's totally a hit.
19, 4 damage. As he comes up behind you and cuts you across the side.
Tell him he's going to need a new apron.
Svelton's going to grab it and look at him and be like, really? You'd cut a girl? Teenager, really?
A young adult.
In response, another thug attacks Svelton. Nat 20.
That's a miss.
I figured. Really? Touch attack, even? So yeah, that's a confirmed crit.
Pistol, it's times 4.
Yeah, so you take a whole 4 damage. So the gun sort of, it doesn't misfire, but he must have packed it wrong, because although the bullet hits you like in the neck, it's like a grazing hit. This guy moves forward and uses his 2 attacks on Svelton. So the first slash you easily deflect, and the second one is completely wide. This man comes forward and whistles for his hounds to attack.
Oh shit, it's the Hound Master.
Have you played Darkest Dungeon, Lamette?
can cleave targets.
Yeah, but I stopped because it's insane. But
some of these people get up. Some of them are shouting and sort of screaming, and many of them begin to sort of flee.
Yeah, I'll let you go.
I was going to tell them to do that.
Simply patrons.
That's why you don't show up to shitty places.
I guess so.
Do I give Gamery a shield extract, or do I drink my mirror?
These people.
I don't think we need
scuttle
it.
Scuttle away.
Does Anna have like charm animal or anything?
No.
Suddenly, a man bursts out from the next room and attacks Anna.
Oh shit! Oh,
I'm a little girl. Don't kill me. I didn't do anything.
I already tried that with them. It doesn't work.
Oh, Jesus.
Critical.
Yeah. They also love crits.
I crit? Wow.
Guys, I have bad news. I'm
dead. Yeah, I'm about to fucking lose my mind.
So that's 9 plus 8 is 17.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, that's a crit.
Confirm critical.
Is that a confirm?
Times 2. Yeah, times 2 on a longsword.
26.
Crit a lot.
26 damage.
Your AC is 9 or...
No, no, it's 17.
No, it's right? Plus 8. So Anna gets her head cut off.
She You're not dead.
Ground. Yeah, I'm dead.
26 no. damage?
26 Come damage. On. I have 15 HP total.
What's your constitution?
8. Less than that. Yeah, I'm dead.
No. Want to be Garibaldi?
Yeah, I'm dead. Thanks, Benzo. Yeah, appreciate it.
24.
Wow. Why am I feeling Herman all over again?
I was going to say, just her in the fuck out correct? Of her.
I take 23 damage. Yeah, negative 8. That kills me. Anna dies. She falls
down. Oh, shit. Well, so Benzel tanks.
Can I use my karma point?
Yes.
The backroom longsword.
I can't do anything.
Let's go karma point? I don't know. I don't think you
yes,
can do
I'll take karma point.
I mean, to do what? Like, what can I?
Have them reroll?
Wow.
Get him to reroll damage.
I mean, literally, he did like maximum damage, and it is like what he needs to kill me instantly. So, I mean, I guess it's up to you, Benzel. Like, I don't know if that's.
Did we get a heads up about there being a back room?
Yeah, I thought it was the entrance.
I thought that
to be
was
honest.
The front door too. Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that's where we came in from.
We obviously came in from the stairs.
Because, yeah,
why is it,
as long as he mentioned that was a thing, then it's pretty legit. Stairs,
yeah, that's where Pike came from. He came out of that door.
Oh, really? But then why is he over here? Well, because he moved there.
Yeah,
because I thought it was the entrance.
I mean,
who
regard
really like Dana anyways?
Regardless. I mean, I do, but if she's dead, like, I'll live with it.
Shit.
Like, what do you think of Benzel? You just want to roll with it? I'm just dead now.
No, I'm looking at rules here for any wiggle room.
You have wiggle room, which is basically you could gave him a karma point, you could get him to re-roll something. So whether that be damage, one of the attacks, or instead of doing an all or nothing confirm crit, you could roll the two separate.
Benzel's a legit DM.
Did you roll to confirm 9? Is that
yeah.
a...
Yeah. And then it was plus 8.
Plus 8.
Eight to it. Yeah.
Holy shit.
Arguably, I'm also flat-footed because I haven't gone yet, so... Literally, a guy just pops out of a room and cuts my head off. I die.
I mean, you built Anna to be pretty delicate, I guess.
Well, yeah, but... Yeah.
I would honestly, like, use the karma point, get him to reroll the damage.
You know what I'm going to do? I am going to roll the second set of damage.
Instead of
just multiplying it by 2.
I hope he rolls another 8.
Yeah, what if he rolls?
And then like, I'll be
I
like,
don't
well,
hope he does, but, like, I hope he does.
You know what? Yeah, and that's
okay, that's fair.
Well, as long as Matt thinks so.
Huzzah!
He rolled an 8.
That's how the character sheets do it. So
I think it's legit.
Aren't you alive now?
Well, I mean, I'm dead, but I'm not dead. I'm not.
You're dying.
Right.
I didn't have to touch. That was legit.
Wait, does it? Hold on.
No, because.
Why is this
15 HP
still...
plus the 8 con?
It says a critical hit means that you roll your damage more than once with all your usual bonuses and adds.
I thought I was a rule Nazi. You're bad.
Oh, hold on. I
just want to kill her.
15 HP minus 3, so I'm down to 2. And then minus. Yeah, so why? Yeah, I'm still dead. So.
Oh, you are dead?
Yeah.
Really? Even after that?
Yeah. Use a karma point to make him reroll the first damage roll.
I'm at -8.
Yeah, did you have a karma point?
I don't know. I mean, it's kind of up to Benzel. Like, I would prefer not
Benzel's
to get killed.
Just going to give you a karma point for
like
dying.
I'm just saying, like,
role
I would
play,
prefer...
Roleplay your like... death, and then depending on how good you do it, he'll give you a karma point.
No, how badly... Like, what at this new 23 damage... What,
I mean,
how much damage
at,
can you take overall?
23. I'm at exactly what I need.
No way. He rolled the exact thing twice.
Guys, this was meant to be.
Shut up, Russell. I would just prefer not to just have my head cut off by some
random dude. I'm going to say that you're not dead yet. People can. There are people in the convening turns who can
you're
do
such
actions.
You're such a GM.
Well,
you never
she's
want to
at,
kill people.
She's at 23, so it's I think die. One roll is not bad.
But like if my AC is 18 and you roll an 18 to attack me, do you hit?
Yes. Yeah, if you get blindsided with like no. Now I'm not saying Benzel is cheating,
is that
just to say I'm not saying like oh
no,
Benzel.
He's doing the opposite. Yeah. I would have had this.
I'm saying the opposite.
Right now.
I'm saying yeah. Benzel is trying to fluff it so you
after
don't
my
die.
Next turn.
Fine.
Oh, because like
Anna dies. She dies.
I'm gonna give you a turn to roll.
You have 6 seconds.
Someone please help me.
You have 6 seconds.
Yeah, Beard, I got you.
Is there any NPCs still attacking Benzel? Let's get the show on the road.
Yes, there is. This guy comes out of the room, pushes past his friend, and stabs Anna.
Nailed it.
Come on.
I came here.
No, he can't get past his friend. He's gonna just wait there for now.
Perfect leave targets.
So this guy unleashed his hounds. They're going around.
Holy shit.
I believe that is the end of the NPC's turn. Sir Gamry.
Sir Gamry, notices Anna fall, but it's like, she wouldn't heal me.
Oh, wow.
Gamry, get in front of me. I'll give you a shield. Gamry, get in front of me. I'll give you a shield.
Must cleave.
Okay. Oh, my
Gamry,
fuck.
Gamry gets a +1 on his first attack because of his sheath. So that's on the guy in front of him, the orangey.
I'm not healing Gamry.
+1 damage. Is 14 a hit on orangey?
Yep, it sure is.
So it'd be 16 damage. And
so
then he cleaves Louie?
Slash the guy. Oh, right, because you've got cleave.
Yeah, but the whole furious damage bonus thing doesn't apply on the second attack, I don't think.
Let's so hit. I made
acros.
Another 10.
Yes.
Fail your
stabilize check.
Where's my wife?
Thanks for not protecting me, Gamry.
I'm protecting you by killing them all.
No.
You gotta heal Anna.
Yeah, but I needed you.
Nameless girl.
Sveltna?
1, 2, 3. I'm gonna draw my shield when I'm here.
Okay.
And then move in. This guy's probably gonna get an attack for opportunity on me.
No, you only.
So I was gonna like
into his space. You didn't.
This
yeah,
guy
I'm
is
gonna,
actually
like, push you out of your way. I'm gonna like push you so I can be beside Anna. I'm gonna heal her.
Okay. You can heal.
The belt.
But you can't just put the belt on someone else, can you?
No. You can use it on other people.
And pelvic thrust into people and just heal them.
All right, so he shoved me out of the
just
way.
Just gonna fucking scissor with her a little bit. Once the juices start flowing, she just fucking springs back to life.
Luke, I think you need.
But yeah, I'm gonna drop all the charges.
You need to have another toke, man. You're getting too much energy.
Okay, so you can go ahead and throw that down.
When did the 12
feet? Thank you.
I'm gonna put my hand on your chest and bring you back to life and lean
so,
in and whisper.
So the man comes out of the room and basically stabs Anna through the midsection and pulls his sword out, and she falls to the ground like bleeding profusely. At which point, Sveltna comes over and uses her wondrous item to heal her.
Beard planned this. He put that item in his adventure only for this.
Oh, thank God. Well, yeah.
That's why I was like, yeah, Luke, you can have it.
I thought
it
was
sure D8, no
guys.
It.
Whose dumb idea was this?
Gorgon.
Gorgon turns to Yang and said, looking over his shoulder with his combat awareness, says, go to Anna.
Oh, sorry. I kind of skipped.
Oh, yeah. No, you don't need
to. That's okay.
You
can stab
you skip.
Again.
You skip.
Oh. Don't worry. You can just stab me again while I'm down on the ground here. This time it'll be more legitimate. As soon as Anna regains consciousness, she sort of like looks to Sveltna for a moment, and you can see like terror on her face, and she's gonna look at this dude, and I guess I'm prone, eh? I'm gonna 5 foot crawl up these stairs, and then I'm gonna use my slumber hex on him.
Crawling upstairs wouldn't be very hard though, really.
So he needs to make will save.
Okay. Will save.
I hope he succeeds because Yang wants to fucking kill him.
That one.
He's asleep. He just falls down.
Coup de grace. Perfect revenge.
Okay. Sorry, now we're back to Gorgon.
Gorgon says, move beside Anna, ensure she stays alive. As for you, Pike, he lifts his gun as if he's going to shoot it, then stabs him with his wrist blade. So he gets a perception versus my sleight of hand. So last time I rolled my wrist dagger sleight of hand, which I shouldn't have done. But...
Well, I'm glad you owned up to it.
No, it was only minus
anything?
Two. No. Okay, so here's my attack roll. He's flat-footed. 12 versus his flat-footed.
I don't think that quite does it. Let me just look.
You have studded armor or higher?
Flat-footed will be, yeah. Unfortunately, that is not a hit.
I missed.
So he doesn't see the attack coming, but when you attempt to stab him, it... is stopped by his chain shirt.
Less. Cool.
You might be muted or something, perhaps?
Oh, I will drink my mutagen.
Les, you should protect Anna from behind if you can move up a space.
All right.
Is this the... can
upstairs.
I just get a quick dimension here, Benzel? So, like... Can this dog get up this way? Is my question.
No.
That's okay. A stairwell.
Sorry, I originally thought it was like a staged or an elevated point. So, gotcha.
Oh, I see. No, this is a stairway that you guys
leading
came
that
down
way.
From.
I see it now.
So, gotcha. My mutagen's a standard action, right? Am I able to use a heal or a bomb or anything now, or is it just a move?
Nope.
Okay.
No. Yeah. You can only do.
You well, should still stand in front of Anna.
Before I end my
you could
turn,
hand you could hand Anna a potion.
I can hand
that
her a potion.
That would be your move. Yes, you can, but you can't administer it on her.
Well,
so you could give it to her so she could use the action on her turn. I mean, she could just heal herself
for
that
HP,
matter,
Anna?
But
Four.
Three.
Yeah,
four?
I'm going to hand you a potion to use, because it's it'll save you a spell, and it's equally effective as your spells, I think. And I'll stand in front of you, I guess. But yeah, I'd like to point out that if Anna had died there, she would have been completely proved right in everything she's been saying.
And what? What did I say?
Just that what we're doing, it's not right. What we're going to do, it's dangerous. And you always want to avoid like the violence and stuff. And then we come in here and start a fight. And then you get chopped down.
Just dead immediately. Yeah. I
like,
know. Part of me.
Shit.
Part of me is like, maybe Anna should go here. But the other part of me, like, I don't know. Just getting blindsided. I'm like, I don't know if I want to do that. I think Anna can do a little bit more. However,
I would have been sad.
Still be sad, but that's the best time to let characters go sometimes. Like, I'm sure I'll wake up tomorrow and I'll be like, I wish Anna died, but it would have been great for
He said story. Creating wish, a gunslinger.
Your wish is my command. I am going to throw a bomb.
And I actually straight up would make a gunslinger.
I was thinking if Gorgon died, I'd make a gunslinger.
That's my turn.
I was thinking I would make a gunslinger.
Race to who dies first.
I'm changing Les's class on. Again to gunslinger.
I was thinking I would make a gunslinger.
We should just be a party of gunslingers.
Are we going or can I go to sleep?
And we could all be pirates.
Sure.
Les?
Les is turned over. I passed my turn like three times.
Oh, sorry. My mistake. Thrindle. Let's see here. I guess he's gonna push past this guy. Should probably use a spell, I suppose, eh? I will go to I'm gonna go to here, I suppose, and cast color spray.
Good, Trindle.
Okay, saves. Reflex is a pass. Or no, that's not reflex, it's will. Nat 20 is a pass. Okay, who else? This guy. It's a save. Oh, he also passes. So, Gamry, Thrindle comes over and blasts a spell past you, but the men stand there unfazed. Yang.
Nice fairy dust.
All right. So Yang, looking at Anna fall down, is almost going to charge at the person who harmed her, but seeing how the situation is resolved, he quickly like goes back to focusing on the thing that is important. Seeing how Gorgon is taking care of Pike, he will try to get rid of that blue dude. And he will do his double attack shtick thingy. So I will try to slice him first with my scabbard. It is a 20 versus his AC for 3 damage.
It's a hit.
And finally, here's the big katana attack. 17 for 4 damage.
I believe that is also a hit. Just let me check.
What? 7 damage total.
Yeah. Oh, and an additional 4, was it?
Yep, 4 plus 3. Wait a minute. I think that katana does more damage than this. Yeah, it's supposed to do...
Isn't it a d10?
Yeah, but it's not counting my strength, I see. So let me just check my strength bonus. It's it's 3, so it should be 7 damage. So 10 total.
Yeah, so your first attack, your scabbard didn't add your strength.
Yeah, it adds plus 1 because that's the one I count as an offhand. And my katana.
You attack with your offhand first, so edgy.
Yeah, I know. The katana's the edgy one.
So
brutal.
So it was 10 total altogether, right?
Yes.
Excellent.
So, oh yeah, so it has a minus four. It shouldn't have that. Oh, that's so. Okay, so not.
Yang bats the man across the face with his scabbard just in time to stab him in the belly. The NPC's turn. This man will attempt to push past the door in that. I'm going to make him do a CM. Or no, an acro. What should I do here? Strength. Oops, that's not the dice I wanted. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. What are you?
The guys in the world. Oh, it's all right. We've moved on.
Yeah, no, other dudes are showing up.
Pikes attack on Gorgon. 19, Gorgon.
19 is exactly a hit.
12 damage.
Ooh.
Okay, this guy does a 5... Where is he going to go? Yeah, he'll do a 5-foot step and do 2 attacks on Yang. First attack is a 22.
Hit.
7 damage. Second attack is a 22. 7 damage. Wow. So he sidesteps and does 2 quick stabs.
I have 6 HP.
So the guys with the guns begin reloading. More people flee. I'm just going to delete them right off, I think. And this guy will move forward. 10, 15, 20,
I'm going to need some fucking heals, my dudes. 30, 35.
40, he's going to go to there, and he will attack... Or wait, no, that's 40. So he can't... he'll move to there, I suppose. This guy will step forward and attack Thrindil. Okay, so 2 hits on Thrindil, stealing 17 damage.
Yikes.
Okay. Attack on Sir Gams. As the man attempts to stab you.
Critical.
Oh.
6 damage. Ah, poor Gams.
Gamry falls down.
Oh, that's plus 3, so that's 20 total, probably confirmed.
Yeah.
Okay, so you take, and I'll give you the same benefit of rolling it twice.
Oh, wow.
5 damage total.
Yes.
And that's it.
Dogs?
Yes, you're right, the dogs. This one moves forward and attacks Sir Gamry.
Miss.
12. This one goes here and attacks Sir Gamry, getting flanking. 20, probably
get flanked, bitch!
4 damage.
4 damage total as he bites you on your leg.
Damn it.
Okay, is that everybody? Yeah. This one, I guess, can move in. This guy disappears. Okay.
I like how Gordon
passed Sir Gamry. Gamry.
Okay, so Sir Gamry attacks the dog first.
Hoping for that cleave.
Yeah.
Definitely a hit, yeah. So Gamry chops the dog in 2.
Oh.
And then clocks the man. Wait a second. Did that do the damage? Or did it do it in the wrong order?
He did 1 damage.
Wait a second. 20 and 17. And then 20.
That was on the dog. Then there's just 2 d20 rolls for some.
Oh, I messed up the macro. Oops. I'm just going to roll the right macro.
It's cleave.
Yeah, like I'm not supposed to do the furious damage twice.
It looks like you did hit. You just need to roll your damage roll.
Well, I'm going to use my other macro for the damage roll, but take 3 off the damage here. So it'd be 16.
And who was that on? Sorry?
The orange dot.
Okay, that... So this man, you do a horizontal slice, and you cleave partway into his, sideways into his chest, and then pull your sword out, killing him instantly. Well, not instantly.
No one survives.
He's laying on the ground trying to breathe. But, yeah. Okay, do you continue cleaving then? Is that how this works?
No, that's how great cleave works.
One cleave.
Yeah, greater cleave. Oh, you only get one. Just fucking go down a line.
Yeah.
It's coming.
Okay.
So is this guy sleeping?
Yeah.
Yeah, so Anna's holding her stomach, and she says, Sveldnug, kill him.
Sveldnug's going to coup de grace. She's just going to grab her chakram and start slamming down on his throat.
And now just tactically, I promise you it's not a waste because he's only asleep for 3 turns. So it's worth killing him now.
So yeah, you just coup de grace. You basically do whatever you would like. And
does he get a karma point? It only seems
how
fair.
Would you... Yeah, you get a evil karma point. What would you like? Do you have any specific manner?
He's getting killed.
Would like to
I'm going to grab him. Gonna grab his by the hair, and then start
sawing.
Not really sawing, more like hacking at his neck until I have his head clean off. And then
okay.
See, it looks like you and I are not so different still, no? We're both the most evil of the party. Gamry's just psychotic.
Oh, yeah, no, there's definitely equivalency between a guy who did nothing getting killed in a slow, torturous way and a person who, mortally wounded a friend.
This isn't his first butchering of people, though.
Fair enough.
And is coup de grace a full round action?
I believe it is, yeah.
It is.
Okay.
Yeah. So, Anna gon' cast sleep.
Okay.
So I'm going to use my gloves to overcharge, and I don't have a overlay, I don't have a way to check the range, but I'm fairly confident that
it's pretty far. It's 100 feet or so.
I mean more the area itself.
But I'm not 100%
fairly confident that the only
place, 10 or 20 feet radius or something
that I can do effectively are these 3 people. So,
okay.
Sounds
these 2 good.
Samurai Jack over here, this Slim Shady and.
Yeah, I gotcha. These guys,
Cap Sparrow or whatever. So they can make their will saves. And again, I am overcharging, but I'm using the gloves.
Here's one will save coming up. So, first will save, 18.
That's pass.
Second will save. Is a 16.
That's pass.
And
that's pass.
Another 16.
Well, Anna lays down on the floor.
And those were just plain D20s, those last two, so what do you do?
Yikes.
They brush
the shenanigans.
Yeah, I guess so. I'll be right back in just a moment. Gorgon, prepare for your turn. I'll be right back.
Never. I'm in a delay.
So suddenly half of these people lose their legs and a wooden peg leg grows out of the wound and their sword becomes scimitars. Some of them lose their
cutlasses.
Hands.
Scimitars are Arab.
That's true. Cutlasses.
Yeah, this isn't your Trump 2009 adventure. Oh my god, new idea.
Yeah. I thought you were going to say French Legionnaire.
A friend of Warren Gear will appear with luscious blonde hair, super buff, and he's be like,
I've got an adventure for you. It's the biggest adventure you've ever seen.
It's going to be so much loot, the best loot. It's about
building. It's the best loot.
I'm trying to build a wall.
All right.
Which so one you'll of these? Go, so you'll go in this other country and make them pay for it. Just like...
Yeah, all those Syrians came through the border. Which ones are terrorists? Trick question. They're all terrorists.
These Cloverans, some are good people, I assume.
Others are rapists. They're drug dealers.
If Arabians use cutlasses, would Saudis use planes?
No, it's pirates that use cutlasses.
Oh.
Arabians use scimitars.
Oh.
Are you back, Benzel?
No, we gotta talk about pirates some more.
Do-do-do-do-do. The one's wearing a pirate hat.
The dogs transform into parrots.
You wonder what's cooler than a pirate?
What bone do you think that is that's always with the skull and crossbones? Like, what bones do you think those femurs. Are that are crossed?
They're femurs, for those sure.
Are femurs.
That's where the peg legs come in.
They're not... Yeah. Femur. Well, let's see. Well, femur is not the peg leg.
There's no answer to this question.
No, but peg legs and femur is not the same.
Yeah, I know. You're right. I don't know. It's a tibia and a fibia is what's down there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
and that bone doesn't look anything like the bone on the.
Like you said, the tibia and the amphibian.
Yeah.
The amphibian.
Only the truest, most hardcore pirates have femur peg legs because their whole leg is a peg.
Their whole leg is one. They have a broomstick down there. Can't bend on the knee, but who cares?
Just no joints in his left leg.
Okay, Gorgon.
All right. I delay until after Yang.
Less. Oh, really?
Yep.
Less will...
I want to go after Yang, but before the enemies.
5-foot step.
Okay.
I'm really scared of this fucking guy.
Oops. Oh, this guy right here is the token for our ally.
Oh, well, good.
I kill him!
I'm gonna huck a bomb at you because you're trying to kill my friend.
Oh, you can actually slide my initiative from now on after Yang.
Yeah.
Just so I don't get forgotten.
Okay, so 15 touch attack with another blinding bomb on this guy. 6 damage, and it would be 5 damage to him. And they actually get reflex saves on that too. I forgot. The splash damage.
Why aren't you throwing at this guy?
Which guy? I'm throwing it at him. Because I can't hit both of these people because you're always like, 5 feet, man.
Yeah, but that's 5 feet.
That's 10 feet in every direction. Oh, for fuck's sakes. Fine.
No, it's from your splash.
I throw it at him then and I splash it at these guys. I've actually have said that in prior games. Like, oh, I want to hit this guy and this guy. And you guys are like, no, 5 feet.
For some reason
I think that that's wrong, but anyways.
Well,
what's wrong?
They're correcting me again.
That Carl is mistaken, but I'm.
Oh yes, Carl is mistaken.
Yeah, but I'm still only telling. Do I come up with rules on my own? I'm only telling you what you guys told me. I was trying to do shit like this, and you were like, no.
So either way, it's our fault.
Yo, find it on your stream.
Guys, let's continue on here. So Carl throws a bomb. It hits Buddy here as primary target. Buddy is secondary. Other Buddy is secondary.
Now,
they all get reflex.
They all get fortitudes.
Combat with an ally, so you're good.
They all get fortitudes, and these two get reflexes.
Sorry.
Okay, so the guy who got hit with it got 23 for the guy who got hit.
His 42, or 20. He passes. Yes. It's 14 DC for everything.
Okay, this other guy's reflex. First reflex is 8.
8?
So that's a fail.
Okay, so he gets 5 damage.
Second is 16.
So he passes. No damage. Oh, half damage, sorry. So 2? Unless he's got evasion. Does he have evasion?
No.
So then it's 6 damage on him. And then one of them, it's 5 damage. The other one, it's 2 damage. And then what's the fortitude saves on the other two people?
They get fortitudes as well?
Yep.
Right, we'll no, it's not, the... it's yes, not it both is. Fortitude and reef. What?
Yes, it is. I'm looking it's at a blinding it. Bomb. They get dazzled. Anyone hit by the splash can get dazzled. Not blinded, but dazzled.
Well, one of them will fail, this guy.
It's my alchemical weapon.
Just gonna put
Yeah, I just looked it up. I don't know alchemists that well, to be honest with you, Carl.
How long are they blinded for?
They're blinded for...
Only the central target's blinded. The other two are dazzled.
For 1 minute.
So the central target's blinded. The other ones are dazzled, which is minus one to attack.
That's going to be useful.
Okay. Could be. You never know.
It's a little debuff anyways.
Yeah, it wears off after a minute, I think.
Six damage on this guy. Okay. So Leslie throws a bomb, which explodes. Dealing devastating damage.
Yes, 1 minute.
Thrandall will stand right where... No, hold on. I'll take a 5-foot step. And I'm going to
beside a dog, eh?
Yeah, you're right.
Get out of there, Thrandall, Gorgon shouts in character.
I suppose. You know what? I'll go
backwards.
I'll go here, and then I'll cast Color Spray, and I can hit all three of those guys. And not Yang. So they'll get saves. Wow. Pass. Wow, pass. Wait, no, okay, the first one failed.
It's like, why even be spellcaster?
Yeah, exactly, right. So this guy is...
They are saving pretty well.
I think we over-nerfed you guys.
Oh, I don't think so. I think we're just...
You know what? As we accelerate or get higher in level, it will not be quite as bad. So two of them are knocked under. It's going to be these two.
Oh, thank God. Okay. Man. He's dangerous.
Yang.
So, Yang will. So, this is.
Eat chips.
That guy is defenseless. He's stunned. Dropped his weapon and he's blind.
I will do a coup de grace.
Okay.
Can I just kill him?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yang disposes of the man in whichever fashion he wishes to.
I
cut his guts out.
Yeah. That's pretty much what I do.
Really? You cut his across the stomach and pull his guts out?
Well, I stab him. I stab him in his guts and I twist, you know?
Jesus.
Make sure he's dead.
The fuck so Gorgon's rolling a sleight of hand check, so that's 16 versus Pike's perception check.
11.
Okay. So Gorgon manages to get a grenade out without him noticing, and he's going to throw a grenade. That would hit Yang. I was hoping Yang would move back.
But if you make a ranged attack from there, you're going to provoke, aren't you?
That's what the sleight of hand's for.
Oh, okay.
Actually, yeah.
I would make
more sense. Have evasion. Yeah, it's going off here, but I have to roll a fortitude.
This might not be set with the proper measurements. Just a moment, let me check. Might not be set for Pathfinder. Yes, it is. Never mind.
Yeah, Gorgon's going to do it like that, and hopefully it doesn't hit me. So everyone has to make a reflex save DC 15.
Everyone?
No.
You're scaring me, bro.
Holy shit,
this first guy fails.
Corky so does Gorgon.
Second guy...
fails.
What was the DC again?
15.
15.
Yeah, he fails, and then the last guy, Pike.
Fails.
Jesus, I failed. That sucks.
He
fails as well, so they all failed.
And so does Gorgon, so... Whoop! 14 damage.
Oh. You risky devil.
So a grenade explodes in the corner, flinging metal pellets everywhere.
Yeah.
Striking the men. Cry out in pain. 14. 26. No, no, that's 21. Yeah.
Okay, and that's my turn.
This guy is down to 5. Okay, so the enemy's turn.
Yep.
With things going so poor, some of the men begin to run. The dogs do not seem interested. They begin backing off. This man runs for
smart it. Dogs.
Mostly because their master... Oh, wait, no, he's can't move, so he doesn't...
Run away and live to dogfight another
this
day.
This guy is going to shoot at Gamry.
Ooh.
24 with 1 damage. 30.
The DMs have been rolling like hot fire all night. Anyone oh,
it's
that?
It's crazy. Like, yeah, man. I'm like, I was doing the percentage. I'm like, how long can I hold out in Russell's? I'm like, well, if they're at a +5 and 12, is like, I went through the probability and I'm like, oh, I could last at least about 8 rounds. And then within 3 rounds, I'm like, I'm so hurt.
Yeah.
So that was a touch attack on Gorgon for 3 damage.
That is a miss.
14's a miss. 5.
Yeah. I have 15 touch AC. 30. I have 4 dex and 1 dodge. I have dodge like the feet.
Right. Pike attacks Gorgon.
That's a hit.
8 damage.
Gorgon goes down. Shit.
Use your karma point. GM, give him a karma point.
Does everybody have karma points? Gamry. I have an evil karma point.
So Gamry. So basically, the combat's over now. The only one really left standing and fighting is Pike, and you guys can easily overwhelm him. He backs into a corner.
I would probably charge him and attack him if you just drop right. Gorgon.
Yeah, I think we can do Anish if only to fuck him up then. Cause...
Yeah, yeah Gamry, if you guys want to, that's
Gorgon,
fine.
That's
yeah,
a heal sure. For you whenever it gets to be my turn.
I think we're just going to
I assume Gamry's just going to coup de grace the guys who are right there. So we'll go to Nameless Girl. Gamry chops up the people into little pieces.
Hey, Luke, you just want to wait for one turn?
No.
But then everyone okay. Else will get there.
I just mean I go right after you. I'm just going to try to slumber him, and then you could coup de grace him if you want.
He wants him to be conscious yes. For this.
Well, you missed. So.
So Pike is steadying himself on the table a little bit as you... lunge forward to attack. He deflects the blow. Anna, you can slumber. Now slumber.
Slumber. He gets will save. Fail. He falls down.
So he's,
yeah. How's it feel?
Does he drop now, strike and attack for opportunity?
I don't think so.
He's going to fall into my spear.
Only if you use your karma point.
No.
Well, I mean, you can just coup de grace anyways, so
someone can
either
kill
way,
him
like, yeah.
Here's
the idea. You should let Thrindle do it.
The rest of the thugs make a break getaway.
8 HP, Gorgie.
Keep Carlos.
Gorgie.
What was it? 9 HP? Gorgie.
It was 8. Do you need 9?
I'm also drinking the potion that... Leslie gave me a while ago.
Am I getting healed at all?
Oh, it is a Leslie potion.
It depends if Gorgon is...
This is mainly tap water and bath salts.
Yeah, I'm not entirely convinced that Leslie hasn't ascribed to, like, fucking... What is that called?
He's a holistic alchemist.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Yeah.
8 HP.
One part
Yang?
Healing potion to 99 points water.
When you water down these potions,
yeah, I'll
overcharge.
The problem is they're too strong. You're my hero.
Okay, I was gonna overcharge.
Did you get that 8?
No, I didn't. I'll give myself that.
My last 3 potions were all almost max.
Okay.
Thurindel.
I'm not 14 HP.
What HP is Thurindel missing?
A lot. Half.
Lots.
Lots. Okay.
Like 17 or something.
It's my other.
Gorgon
overcharge.
Gets up and immediately starts apologizing. He says, "I'm sorry. I must have messed up the arc. There's no reason that should have hit me."
Let's laugh just like that.
And he starts studying it. Like, remember when he tried to blow up that statue and failed? He starts like going over the numbers and looking
so
at.
Are we gonna call? Call it after we wrap up this little.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Seems like a good spot. Yeah.
So after taking down all of the thugs, you begin going through the place and just sort of kicking out whoever's still left. There's a couple like patrons that are still around here and there. You find some gold, of course, and some drugs and that, but Mr. Bailey says that these rewards will go towards paying the overdue rent.
That's so
unfortunately
fine by,
you won't
yeah,
the drugs?
Gorgon says that's fine by me. The problem is they're protected by Hazard. And I think we have a long outstanding feud versus him.
Right. Also, I kind of missed this, but my intent was not only for you guys to clear this place out, but to stick around for at least like a few days to probably like a just under a week so that they've got like a bit of muscle around while they move new people in and sort of clean the place up a little bit.
Sounds fun.
Cool. But if any time's passing, just let me know.
Yeah, well, we'll start off next week from just about here, soon after this event.
Mm-hmm. I'm probably going to sleep here to make sure no one comes back, and if they do...
I guess we're all sleeping.
Yeah, for the unconscious people,
well, no,
Gorgon wants to knock them out, and we can turn them into Balaw.
Yeah. Okay.
Does anyone have a rope?
There's also some vicious dogs. No, we definitely don't have.
Can't
rope.
We just release the dogs? Like.
Can if you want.
Why? So that these super vicious dogs can just run around the city?
Yeah, we'll just send them outside. They're not our problem anymore.
All right, guys. It was really good. I got to work real early in the morning, so I'm going to sleep.
Yeah,
I
got to go too.
Yeah,
everybody knows I got my mulligan, so I set the ground rule for everyone gets one.
Everybody gets one.
Which
thanks,
is
guys.
That?
It was real good. It was enjoyable.
If you think about PC deaths,
even.